Hey, what's going on? This episode of the podcast is brought to you by Loot Crate. Do you like awesome geeky t-shirts? Do you like collectible figurines and you have so many of them, you have a whole room dedicated to them? Are most of your friends also cats? I'm just kidding. I'm not saying that people that have collectibles just love cats, but most of you do. Anyway, if you like those things and other kind of like geeky gadgets, then Loot Crate is perfect for you because what they do is they're a subscription service that sends you a box of awesome stuff. It's basically like Comic-Con in a box every month. And at one low monthly rate. So it's pretty cool. I've been getting it for a while. So it's Blue and Stitch. The rest of y'all.
Coming.
Coming soon. All right.
Probably tomorrow.
You don't need to do it quickly.
I need to order the pet version for my dog.
Oh, yeah. That's what Stitch gets, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to try that. Well, I don't really. Maybe I should try it out. You know, I'm Scrappy.
You probably do have
like
a dog.
It. Yeah, yeah. So they got you covered no matter what you got. If you like gaming, they have Loot Gaming. If you like pets, they got Loot Pets. If you like a bigger box, if you're balling out of control, you can get the Loot DX. That's a bigger box. It's more expensive, but it comes with cooler stuff.
And if you're not balling, they also have the Loot Crate Wear, which is just a t-shirt they send you.
Yes, t-shirts and other kinds of wearables like... I think like socks and stuff.
Yeah, and I think they just partnered up with Crunchyroll too. So there's a Loot Crate Crunchyroll box that they start doing.
Snap! That'd be dope. I want to get a Mob Psycho 100 shirt.
That's a good anime. We're gonna talk about that
anime. Yeah. Anyway, if you do us a favor, go to trylootcrate.com/bethembti and enter the promo code Bridge10, like a bridge you're walking over number 10. You would do us a huge favor. So yeah, you also save 10% on your. First month of subscription. So once again, go to trylootcrate.com/BTI with the promo code of Bridge10 to save yourself 10% on a new subscription. And don't forget, you have to go to the, you know, /BTI or we don't get the credit for it. It's not just the promo code. Anyway, now on with the show.
Captain, we're receiving a transmission.
What is its point of origin?
It's emanating from the dankest spot in the universe.
But that could only be...
the Infinity Base! Blacker than black times infinity is back!
Oh my.
Hey, this is Matt.
Joe.
And Becky.
Host of Pre-Recorded Live from the Mistake on the Lake, and you are listening to Blacker than Black Times Infinity.
There is a story so strange in its implications that it defies ordinary classification.
I don't care if you've been trying to save Siri from the Wild Hunt all night. If you up, smash that like button. Welcome to Black and the Black Times Infinity. I'm your host, Cthulhu's Prodigy, coming to you live and direct from the Dro. Smoke me out, fam, with that dang shit on my left. Old Ninja.
Some of you need to realize that Harambe was kind of an asshole.
And God damn.
So, yeah, I had to do what I had to do. Hillary 2016.
Oh, this motherfucker. Flip over this table. On my far right, engineer on the ones that choose to peculiar out on the threes and fours, Kronos.
My boy Harambe, Ijima.
Ah, there we go.
He got shot.
Last but not least, we got your boy Blue.
Body asleep, mind awake. Body asleep, mind awake. Body asleep. Podcast on fire.
Nice. Stitch will not be joining us tonight. He is saving the city with his archery gear and fucking red green hood. I don't know what color his fucking hood is. Whatever.
Black, it's black.
Black hood. All right.
It's got that black and black time infinity shirt on.
Holy shit. We back up.
He's a black girl now. He just goes around fucking bitches.
He's trying to fuck Miss Rizzy. From last week, goddamn. Please go listen to that rant. Not even a rant, that proposal.
That shit was hilarious.
People are asking about it already.
Yes, yes. Should we start off with some great shout outs?
Let's do it.
First and foremost, shout out to Kevin and Sobe from Comic Noobs. They landed a world-class, awesome interview. Congrats to y'all. We will be listening. And that is with Tahneisi Coates, the author of Black Panther. So shout out to them. I think they're going to release that on Sunday, if I'm not mistaken.
So they already did it?
But they already did it. They're just doing the editing. Yeah, so that's awesome. I can't wait to
hear it. They edit their shit?
Yeah, they do. Yeah.
Damn.
It's so funny people tell me that. Like, I tell people... Like, people record with us, right? They're like, so when can we have the audio? I'm like, tonight? And they're like, what? I'm like, yeah. I'm like, why not? Well, like, the latest, it might take me, like, 12 hours. That's, like, because I got to sleep. That's about it.
Yeah, no, we put our shit out right on cue.
Mm-hmm.
Live and dank as fuck. So, definitely shout out to them. I'm fucking happy for them with that shit.
Yeah, also shout out to D&G.
Yeah.
You were on the podcast, so why don't you talk about that?
Yeah, so, Gian, half of D&G Talk Shit Podcast, or Daniel and Gian Talk Shit Podcast, was up here in the Bay. They're from L.A., or they podcast out of L.A., and I was on their show in a comic book shop in Union City, which was fucking awesome, and all we did was talk all kinds of fucking shit about mostly comic book movies and figurines and Funko.
Yeah, what's up with your boy throwing shade on Dark Knight?
Yeah, I nearly flipped over the table.
That's all bad.
He gave it like a 4 out of 10.
Yeah, what? He's all like, well, he's all as a comic book movie, it's like a 10 or whatever, but as a movie, it's just like a 4 or whatever. Oh, no, it was reverse. It was as a comic book movie, he gave it a 4, but as a movie in itself, it was like a 10 or whatever. And he's like, it's not a Batman movie, and I was like, I almost threw my phone.
He was a fan of the X-Men movies, though. I was like,
he is, yeah.
And I sleep. Huh?
Yeah.
I don't want to shit on the dude. I mean, you like what you like.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. But I like the X-Men movie.
I wanted to scream at him. The Dark Knight series is like literally live action Detective Comics.
Wait, so I know you like some of the X-Men movies, but you wouldn't say they're like 9 out of 10.
Oh no, they're okay. Like no. 7s, but I think with the Apocalypse one, the reason why I probably scored it so high is because I went in there with really low fucking expectations and it like was like a step above it.
That helps.
So that definitely fucking helps. But was the comic book, was it like a live thing where like people there watching you guys?
Or no,
was it just
no,
like it's a little studio I guess ran.
Shop was closed and it was just the three of us in the shop talking all kind of shit. But yeah, it was really, really fun. And next time they're up here, we're definitely going to, they want you on their Kronos and they're very appreciative of everything you've done. So nice. We'll definitely make that happen. And, you know, the rest of the guys as well at some point down the road.
Yeah, I'd love to go. And they're a new podcast and they're sounding great so far. So yeah, be more than happy to come on, be honored. So yeah.
There you go.
Pretty funny.
Also, a shout out to our listener of the week. It would be Anthony Wells. Thank you for listening.
What's up, fam? Toast to you. Cheers, motherfucker. Right on.
Cheers. Sip my beer.
Yeah.
Sip my water.
All right. So we've gotten some of that all out of the way.
I do got to say, none of you talked about Days of Future Past. Everybody talked about First Class and all that, and I was like, wait, Days of Future Past was a pretty good movie.
That was one of the better ones.
Yeah, I like that one too.
But nobody talked about it when you were on there with it. You guys talked a lot about the MCU. So
yeah. I think the MCU is a whole different level of quality compared to the X-Men movies. But that was a pretty good one for an X-Men movie.
Yeah, because that's all Fox, right? That's not really the.
It is all Fox.
Yeah, it's all fucking Fox. And I mean, we didn't mention it, but shit, Deadpool was, for me, it's a 9
Fox.
Out of 10.
That's a Fox.
That's thing, Fox, too. And it's in that X-Men universe, and Deadpool was fucking awesome.
Yeah,
they did right.
They did. I think that all credit to that goes to Ryan Reynolds, because I think he did a lot behind the scenes to get that on screen and make sure it was true to the character.
For my money, and I know Doctor Strange hasn't come out yet, it's still slightly the best, in my opinion, or my favorite comic book movie from this year.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to give it the slight nod over everything else, even Civil War.
I can feel it. I'm not mad at that.
Yeah. All right. So where should we start first, gentlemen? Should we jump into some comic stuff?
Yeah, we need to have the sound of like opening briefcases or some shit.
What you got, Carlos?
Let's talk about the She-Hulk.
Oh, here we go. Set us up.
Yeah, so apparently they're going to make the She-Hulk comic just called The Hulk. Yeah. And then all these major news networks, once again, fuck it all up. And they're like, oh, yeah, it's going to be the new Hulk and blah, blah, blah. It's the all new Hulk. Blah, blah. I'm like, motherfuckers, there's already a new Hulk, all right? There's already a new Hulk, so shut the fuck up. There's already, before he even died, there was a new Hulk.
Yep.
Like, that was the whole point. But anyway, I'm just frustrated with fucking these major news networks and these fucking idiots that jump all over this shit when they don't have any context in the comic books. You can't claim that this is the new one when there already is one. And he's still around. He's not dead. I don't think he's going anywhere. So.
But then also, the She-Hulk's been around for a long ass time, too. So you can't really say she's new or something like that.
She-Hulk's never been new. She is a Hulk.
Yeah.
There's no doubt about it. She is a true superhero in her own right. She's been a Hulk for a long time. She's not the Incredible Hulk or this new one, the Totally Awesome Hulk. But she certainly doesn't replace the Incredible Hulk Bruce Banner one. That's fucking, what missed me with that bullshit? That's fucking ridiculous. What's
hilarious to me is that all these SJWs and all these other people like jumping all over like, oh my God, yeah, it's going to be a girl, blah, blah. I'm like, well, first of all, she's an established character. And second of all, the current Hulk is an Asian teenager,
mm-hmm.
like a Korean kid. It's like, I didn't see anybody talking anything about that. And it's like, what the fuck?
It doesn't even make any goddamn sense to me because the title, and she's had her own book several times of She-Hulk. has been around for, I mean, look, let's look it up. Was it a 70s character?
It's been a while. Yeah.
I mean, 70s or 80s, it's been a good 30 plus years. And she's one of the better female superheroes in all of Marvel, in my opinion. You know, she's way up there. I think she belongs on the Mount Rushmore of female superheroes.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, she, well, back in the, first appearance was in the 80s.
Okay.
As the Savage She-Hulk. That was, wow, her first appearance was the first comic.
Okay.
That's a special treatment right there.
Oh, wow, she didn't even, like, sidebar with a Hulk or anything. Just no, fucking, no. Here we have a new female comic character.
That's cool.
What's cool about the She-Hulk is she doesn't transform into the She-Hulk. She's She-Hulk all the time, right?
Yeah.
Correct.
Yeah.
And she's a lawyer. She's extremely intelligent.
Mm-hmm.
She's Bruce Banner's cousin, which is obviously very important as well,
mm-hmm.
in terms of how Bruce Banner became the Hulk and her having similar DNA, you know what I mean, to start off with. But she was in A-Force. She mm-hmm. was, you know, she's done a lot of stuff. She's done.
She's been a part of the Fantastic Four too, right?
Yes, she's been, certainly. And she's always kicked ass, to mm-hmm. be honest. She's also on the cartoon show right now, Hulk Agents of Smash.
Okay.
You know, which isn't any good, but I mean, she's fucking on there though. I mean, mm-hmm. she's always been part of that Hulk team. This is just fucking weird.
She just got fucked up by Thanos, though. She's in the hospital.
Yeah, well, so. Thanos gonna give it to you. Yeah. You know, you don't want to fuck around with
fucked
that.
Fucked up Rhodey. Fucked up She-Hulk. He fucked up everybody.
Yeah.
Then he got caught.
Yeah.
But he about to get out, though.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I need Thanos doing shit like that. You know what I mean? Thanos is a true villain. You know what I mean?
We all know that in Civil War, he's going to eventually make another escape because he's getting his own comic in, like, October or December or something like that. So
yeah.
I'll be all over that shit, so.
He's fucking everything, man.
Who's writing that? Is it going to be Starling again?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know. So. We'll have to look that up.
He's, like, the best one.
Yeah, but I'm not in, the only thing I don't like about it is really the title or mantle of Hulk changing, because she's always been She-Hulk.
Yeah.
Keep her as She-Hulk. That's fucking it. You know? It's part of who she is.
That's really weird for them to do that, since she's an established comic book character and she has, like, her own title. Like, why would you just throw her under the Hulk banner?
I'm gonna say she has her own following. You know, there's She-Hulk fans. Independent and separate from Hulk fans. You know what I mean? So, it doesn't fucking make any sense.
Yeah, it's one of those things where they're trying to do the replacement character thing again with somebody that's already established. I'm like, how the fuck are you gonna do that?
What is it like the Falcon becomes Captain America, right? Like, you have this established character. I mean, he's not big time,
Well, that was a reason. There was a reason there, and it wasn't like somebody had already stepped up and took the mantle, and they were like, we're going to give it to somebody else. It'd be like if Rhodey became Captain America, and then all of a sudden they're like, oh, nope, it's going to be the Falcon now. That's literally what they're doing with this.
It's fucking weird, man.
So, you know what? Interesting, you mentioned how, like, you know, She-Hulk should be, like, on that Mount Rushmore for female comic book characters.
Yeah.
Who would you have on that? Who would be the other characters you would have on there?
Oh, that's a great question, Blue.
On the female one?
Yeah.
Females, like, standout A-lister.
DC and Marvel, or just Marvel?
DC and Marvel. Wonder Woman would probably be at the top.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Captain Marvel's another one that's
I put her on there. I'd actually put, even though it's a little controversial, I'd put Phoenix on there.
Yeah,
Jean Grey.
Jean Grey Phoenix.
Yeah.
And I'd put Storm on there. You know, anybody else we could think of?
Catwoman.
Yeah, Catwoman should be on there. I mean, she is an iconic female character.
But she's kind of an anti-hero.
Definitely, yeah, that's what I was just going to go to. Are we only talking about superheroes, or are we talking about villains, too?
I would say just superheroes, just full out.
Yeah, because Catwoman is not a superhero. We're going to get into this a little bit more about what the difference between an anti-hero and a villain.
Mm-hmm.
But Catwoman definitely steals and does some gangster shit and is a villain in the rogue gallery kind of, sort of Batman. She works with him, too. I get that. But she does some heinous shit. Like, Batman doesn't steal jewels.
Yeah, and Batman's constantly arresting her and shit, so she can't be too much of a
definitely hero. Her. You're right.
Yeah, she doesn't at least actively save people, per se, unless it fits her already established agenda of whatever the fuck she's going to do.
If she can benefit from it, she'll save somebody's life.
Yeah, but she is iconic. There's no doubt about it.
Definitely is. I was thinking maybe Hawk Girl or Hawk Woman.
Hawk Girl?
Maybe Supergirl.
I don't think she's up there yet. I think Supergirl might have the... I mean, Supergirl's had her own show twice.
Or Power Girl, too.
That's a harder show.
I'm not quite ready to go Power Girl on the Mount Rushmore of female superheroes.
No, that's true. She's not too established. She's more like a B-C lister for comics, I would say.
Yeah, I put her down there with Jubilee.
Yeah.
Wow.
Anybody else that we're forgetting? Is it too soon for Miss Marvel?
Yeah, it's too soon. Because I was thinking about Alana as well from Saga, but she's not really a superhero, and she's relatively new.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
If we're forgetting anybody, y'all should tweet at us. I mean,
let us know.
I think that's the Mount Rushmore so far.
Mm-hmm. I think that's four. We have four. We have She-Hulk, Wonder Woman, Jean Grey, Phoenix, and who was the fourth one? Storm or somebody else?
We said Storm and Captain Marvel.
Yeah, Captain Marvel.
Okay.
All right, I think that's a pretty decent list.
That's a great list, to be honest with you. That's hella fucking powerful and shit. Should we segue a little bit into a little bit of anti-hero?
Yeah, definitely set it up, man.
So one of the things I'm seeing much more recently, and I talked about this a little bit on DNG Talk Shit podcast, but with Harley Quinn, we discussed her with Suicide Squad. Margot Robbie knocked it out of the fucking park. There's no doubt about it. However, there's a lot going on with her really transforming from a villain into an anti-hero. And I guess I wanted to discuss everyone's take about that change, because we've seen this happen in a similar way, I think, with even Deadpool.
Yeah, definitely.
Being much more villain earlier on and going into anti-hero, and everybody loves him as an anti-hero from the film. Is this a good direction for the character of Harley Quinn?
I personally want to say yes, but I can't really see, like, I only can see her being a hero when she's being forced, like when she's part of the Suicide Squad, where she kind of has to do it. But I can always see her, like, you know, just being Joker's, like, homegirl and fucking up shit. So I can't really see her too much as, like, a big-time hero.
I think she's an anti-hero because she has her own separate comic now, series of comics now. Yep. So she's not just with the Joker anymore. I mean, I have my daughter gets them. Well, I get them for my daughter, and I have a whole bunch of them, and they're all, like, separate shit besides leaving out Joker, so.
Yeah. Then also the Injustice League. She does a fucking great, or the Injustice Gods Among Us comic. She's fucking great in that for as far as being a hero is concerned.
Yeah, and maybe it's because it's how she was introduced in Batman the Animated Series. I strongly prefer her as a little villainous, you know, and I like the fact that she was doing, you know, some terrible things in a lot of ways in a very charming way. I'm not quite ready to believe that she wants to save people or help people, or even only wants to do bad things to criminals, Punisher style.
Yeah.
Or Deadpool style. I don't know. I've read some of the Rebirth stuff, and it's kind of whelmed me, but not overwhelmed, you know, quite yet, because there's that split, and I want her to stick hyenas on motherfuckers. That's really what it is. At the end of the day, I like that aspect of her, and I can't quite get what the revisionist kind of history of, oh, it was all the Joker that brainwashed me into doing anything bad. I'm like,
that shit is sexist.
I don't know.
Only men could do bad things.
Yeah, and that's what I'm seeing from some. I got into this online with a few people, with some of the newer Harley Quinn fans. It's like, well, she left the Joker, and now she's a hero. And I'm like, wait, what? But she did evil things to a lot of people. You know? Fucked up shit. And she wasn't brainwashed.
That's like saying Hitler went to Switzerland, so it's all good.
Yeah, I mean, to my knowledge, the Joker did not have some kind of chemical injection that made her do what he wanted, or any kind of magic, or any of that bullshit, right?
Well, he kind of brainwashed her a little bit. Like, but he got into her fucking head.
He didn't use any agents to change her.
He's not a hypnotist, right?
No.
No, but he got into her fucking head, broke her down, psyche-wise.
But he did that to Jason Todd as well.
But yeah.
With him, he made her believe that he was the victim, that he's the reason. Like, he made her think that he's the hero, and Batman's the villain.
Okay.
Because he talks about how, like, he had a troubled past and, like, you know, he was just trying to get by and this and that.
Let me ask you a real question.
This is the animated series version.
Is she an adult, and has she been an adult when, like, ever since she's met the Joker? I think so, right?
Mm-hmm.
Are we just saying that she was a complete victim, even though she was an adult, and she was not responsible for any of her actions? Is that what we're doing here?
I don't know what her background is.
She was a psychiatrist. She was a doctor.
Yeah, so she's well established, probably a 30-plus-year-old adult woman.
Yeah, but people can be fucking brainwashed.
Okay.
That's not an excuse, though.
Yeah, I I'm sorry, man. I'm not getting it.
It's an excuse because people can be fucking brainwashed. She got fucking brainwashed by the Joker.
So if somebody was brainwashed and they killed your fiance.
I'm not saying she has a fucking pass for being brainwashed. I'm not saying she has a pass, okay, but that's why, that's the way, that's the reason why she is. She's been brainwashed by the Joker. And like, who was it? I think it was, is it Poison Ivy or somebody helped her kind of get out of that? Or no, maybe it was the Batman. I think the Batman tried to Batman tried.
Poison Ivy did a lot too.
Yeah. But she kept going back.
Yeah, she did keep going back. I get
but
that.
But then she became like, what is it called? Some, like, Stockholm Syndrome, is that what it's called?
Yes.
When somebody's been terrorized by a captor or something like that for a long time. They kind of want that in their life.
See, I don't put 100% responsibility on Joker. I give her fair share, because there were times when Joker said, bye, bitch. I don't want anything to do with you.
He fucking abandoned her a bunch of times, too,
and
to get arrested.
And she still did villain shit. Everybody forgets that. You know what I mean? And I don't know. I can't. I put some of the blame as an adult woman on the things that she did. You know?
I agree with that.
So, yeah. But I'm trying to get on board with the anti-hero role. I really am. It's hard because I don't understand her motivation.
Well, it's weird because it's being pushed by the readers, right?
Yeah.
I would much rather have the writers decide to change it on their own, kind of more, I guess, I hate using this word, but organically, you know what I mean? Instead of just having readers that never read a Harley Quinn anything in their fucking life, demanding that she needs to be this anti-hero, you know,
yeah,
that she has to have redeemable qualities because she's a girl. Like, I don't give a fuck about that. There needs to be more female villains as far as I'm concerned, because there's very few good ones.
Yep,
so that's true.
She was one of the best. I mean, I said it in the San Francisco Comic Con cast a billion times. To me, she's the best female villain we have. And if you make her an anti-hero, that goes out the window.
There's always Amanda Waller.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good one.
Would she be an anti-hero?
No, she's just a fucking straight-up villain.
Yeah. But she is evil.
She's all about, like, saving the country and stuff like that.
At any cost, though.
Yeah, that's
I think what makes her an anti-hero.
Yeah.
She's trying to save people, but people are also dying, so fuck it.
Yeah, the old ninja, fucking, you've been quiet as fuck. What the fuck you got to say on this?
Not much. You guys have covered up all the points so far. So.
All right, we'll see. I want to keep liking her. I want to see what Margot Robbie does, and I want to see what happens in Rebirth and all the DC comics with her. But
yeah, I fucking love Harley Quinn. She's just fucking great.
She's appealing to both men and women, to be honest with you. She's one of those few characters that kind of transcends.
Well, every time she's in fucking Injustice, Gods Among Us, she fucking steals the show. Like,
yes.
Have you guys got to Year 5 yet?
No, I'm not on Year 5 yet.
Okay, because that whole scene of her getting out of hell, you guys, did you read that part?
Nope.
Fucking great.
Oh, I think I did. Yeah.
Where she takes down the fucking demon by herself.
I'm pretty sure I read that.
Fucking great, dude.
Well, people underestimate her, and that's what's fun. And then she always has her comeuppance on.
Lobo fucking underestimated her.
Yeah.
I swear to God, if this season of Arrow they don't use that quiver line in it, I'm gonna fucking like revolt and shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean, that was the best thing ever.
Yeah.
Call it the quiver. All right. Where should we go next?
Let's talk about Mr. Robot.
Ooh.
Do y'all see me now, though?
Oh! Hashtag. Carlos was right.
It looks like it.
I'm pretty sure I'm right. I've been fairly certain for a long time. When we were on the tape, it's been fucking months. I called that shit in season one.
Tell them what you're right about, possibly.
That fucking
Tyrell.
Tyrell is one of the personalities of Elliot.
Mm-hmm.
So if you look at the end of the last episode and then the preview of the next episode that's coming on tonight, it pretty much confirms what the fuck I'm talking about.
Yeah, that cab scene where he was just like, do you see him? Do you hear what he's saying? I was like, holy shit.
Because I think Elliot like started to think about it too, like, you know, fuck, who's real in my life? Like, I have Mr. Robot, who I thought was real, and turns out he's my figment of my imagination. Fuck, Tyrell's been gone for a long time. Is he a figment of my imagination too? So, it's fucking crazy.
Well, if this is the case, and I'm leaning way more on Cronus' side now, think about the similarities between both his dad and Tyrell. Both computer geniuses, men in a lot of ways that he looked up to, you know, he had a close relationship to, one way or another.
Well, I want to know, where does Tyrell come from? Because Mr. Robot is obviously his dad, but who's Tyrell?
It's probably just somebody that he created in his mind. It's the person who he should have, who he believes that
he should have been.
Yeah, because he was like a rising star at E Corp in terms of on his way to be, what was it?
The CTO.
CTO, yeah.
So what if it's both? So what if Tyrell was separate and then Elliot kills him and then personified his, like, basically kind of fractured him, and then he took on that whole Tyrell thing. So what if Tyrell's dead, and then that kind of fractured Elliot to where he's got Tyrell as a new personality? So what if Tyrell was once, basically Tyrell was a figure.
Yeah.
When they talked about the gun and what happened, and he asked Mr. Robot, "What did I do?" And he tells him that he shot him. What if he killed him, and all of a sudden Elliot like didn't want him dead, but so he took on his persona, basically.
It's possible, but there were just too many clues that he was never dead to begin with.
See, to me, what doesn't add up is the whole wife and kid thing, and about how they met at Allsafe, and how they were like, how people, how they both interacted, like the whole party thing, how he killed, how Tyrell killed the woman, doesn't seem to add up, because I believe at the same time, Elliot was at a different spot, like doing something else. There's just certain things that don't seem cohesive enough for me to believe. I mean, it is still a possibility. I was also thinking about what if Tyrell was actually like, so rewind, going back a little bit, we had Angela kidnapped and
by BB Wong.
Yeah, by BB Wong. But in this weird like interrogation or like interview type thing
with a kid.
Yeah, so she's kidnapped, taken to a house in suburbia, and like they use this old like Apple IIe Commodore 64 thing, and they're playing a game, and the questions from the game, this little girl who happens to kind of look like her ends up asking her all these questions, and it was just really weird. But then the thing, this is what got me, this is what I was leading up to, is that the White Rabbit mentioned something about how the effects of their parents affected them. So we know how this affected Elliot. What if this same kind of effect happened to Angela and she has split? So what if Tyrell's like really Angela's like split side or whatever? Because she could be technically in a, you know, a lesbian relationship with someone. They could have adopted a kid. All kinds of weird stuff.
That's out there.
But yeah, no, I know. It is a little out there, but, I mean, we don't know with this show.
But no, Elliot fucking kissed her. So if that's really his sister, unless his sister is really
his sister's really Angela.
Yeah.
That would be weird. God,
damn, we're going down
rabbit holes. Yeah, we're going on rabbit holes.
I don't think that.
I'm
keeping it simple crazy.
You looking at two different kind of Venn diagrams.
Yeah, so my thing is that what White Rabbit's character brought up is that how this affected Angela as well. How the deaths of their parents affected one, but we haven't really seen how it affected the other.
That's true.
Real quick, first of all, shout out to Elliot, who won an Emmy.
Yes.
So that was fucking
impressive. He's like the first person of color that's won in like the last few years.
What? Yeah, because he's Egyptian, I believe.
Yeah,
right?
He's part Egyptian.
Yeah. So that was awesome. Secondly, BD Wong in drag fucking works for some reason. Like, it just
does. Is this because he's gay?
He pulls it off. He really does. Like, when he was interrogating Angela, I was like, I didn't think of him as being in drag. I just thought of him as this woman. You know what I mean? Even though we've seen him in a business suit in several scenes all throughout this year and last year.
Well, I have a problem. Every time I see him, I always think of fucking
Jurassic Park.
No, fucking Batman.
He was an Oz. Yeah. Oh, you know, he's also, so he's on, he's Hugo
Strange.
Strange on Gotham, and then he's on Mr. Robot, and I think he's on a third show.
Dude, he's all over the fucking place.
Yeah, so I don't know how he has time. I've been a huge BD Wong fan since 93. Personally, I think he should be like a really huge star by now, but he's just like kind of a B-lister, which I think is just not...
Talent-wise, he's up there.
But the thing is, he's not starring in his own vehicles, even though he brings it, like, every time, I think. And I think he does amazing performances.
When he pissed on that grave.
Yeah.
I can't get
like,
over that.
He fucking squatted. He didn't like.
Yeah, he didn't just stood there. He squatted. Yeah.
Fucking squatted. I was like, fuck, is he your girl? What the hell?
See, go ahead.
No, I was going to say, going back to the interview scene with Angela inside that fucking house, like, that whole scene was a fucking mind trip. Because that little girl, like, she's like, she sat down with, like, hey, you know, did you cry when you have sex? I was like, holy shit, where's she going with this?
Yeah.
That, and it's that a little girl. That fucked me up. I was like, whoa.
And but what's crazy is that, like, she's like, she's, no, we need to hurry because, you know, the water's already running. I'm like, what the fuck is she talking about? But then I noticed in the background, the fish tank water started to get fucking low. Which I was like,
that was weird.
That was really fucking weird. But then, like, the little girl had mentioned how, like, you know, if you don't answer no questions, they're going to beat me. Yeah. And she showed her, like, the fucking scars and like that. Like, that whole scene was pretty fucking mind-trippy.
Yeah, it was. And then it was revealed that it was just makeup.
Yeah, that was makeup.
Yeah, so
the door wasn't locked. She could have just fucking walked out, but she didn't.
Yeah, but she... Well, I thought she tried the door.
There's two doors.
Locked. Oh, that's right. There's a second door. There's a door behind White Rabbit.
Yeah.
That's true.
The little metaphor that he said, like, how, like, a door has an infinite possibilities and stuff like that.
Yeah,
like,
see, that is part of the speech about how I'm thinking that maybe Angela is split as well.
Mm.
So, I don't know. There's all kinds of crazy stuff. We're going to find out tonight. Tonight's finale. Tonight's
finale.
Another thing about that whole Angela scene was like the majority of the episode.
Yep.
It was.
So,
we still don't know about Darlene and...
We don't know. Yeah, we don't know if they're alive.
And Fuckboy.
Nowhere in it. I'm pretty sure somebody's dead, though.
Right, yeah, the guy, I believe. I don't believe Darlene would die like that. Yeah. But we'll see.
And we don't know.
Hopefully. Well, there was a... Hopefully it's not a fucking spoiler, but it was like a picture of Darlene. Like, they said, like, season finale, and it had Darlene's picture on there, so...
Yeah, we'll see. Well, the other real trippy thing, Stitch's FBI girl.
Oh, yeah.
Who is hot
covered in blood.
Well, not even that. Her scene in the room. She's a weird chick.
She's just...
And she's going through a lot, and she's smarter than damn near everybody in the FBI.
Yeah.
But she's faced with...
She's lonely.
Loneliness, her own, like despair or whatever.
Yeah, that scene with her talking to the Amazon Alexa? Yeah, Alexa. Was, like, hella trippy because she's, like, asking, like, personal questions. Like, if she's like, Alexa, do you love me? And stuff like that. Like, she really has some, like, I think she has some kind of issues with her.
Deep-seated.
I mean, when we first got introduced to her, she was fucking laying in the bed, double-clicking a mouse while fucking chatting online and shit.
Yep. So, I can't wait for the finale, man.
It's going to be crazy. We'll see what happens with the... We still haven't seen the FBI. Well, she hasn't caught up with Elliot yet, but she's kind of right behind his heels, but they kind of pumped her brakes and made her go in different directions. So we shall see. I mean, I'm hoping that the finale is more than an hour because I don't think they can explain everything.
Yeah, hopefully.
I mean, we are getting season 3.
Yeah, I hope for an hour and a half.
You know, another thing that was really fucking cool. So I started off the podcast with my whole body asleep, mind awake thing, and that's kind of like something Elliot talks about on the show, where that's how you help yourself to have lucid dreams. Well, like the show starts off with that, but then it ends with him actually waking up and Mr. Robot's in control, and there is a Mr. Robot comes into the house and he's like scrambling for some paper and he finds a Chinese menu,
mm-hmm.
and on there was like some fucking codes, and it was basically a code within a code within a code within a code.
Yeah,
where he got like a fucking phone number where he, when he called the phone number, they gave him like fucking coordinates where he had to go and meet the taxi cab driver, and that's where we see if the struggle between if
him and Tyrell
are like one person or two. So
yeah, it was kind of weird because he was like, Elliot's following Mr. Robot, because the whole time in the first two seasons it's always like Mr. Robot does stuff without Elliot's knowledge, and now it's the reverse, like Mr. Robot's doing stuff but Elliot's watching. And then
silently
we see,
watching.
Yeah, and then we see this point where him and Tyrell meet up, so things kind of weird out. The one thing that got me is that whole the door opening scene. So when Mr. Robot leaves, we see someone who presumably is wearing a suit grab the door also and leave as well. And I think that's supposed to be, I don't know what kind of significance. I mean, it possibly is about one personality coming out of the other, or someone following. We don't know. But it's super tricky. trippy.
We're all just along for the ride with this show.
It definitely is. Great. And what's crazy, like, he asks you too. Like, he's involving the audience into the fucking show. He's like, yeah. Hey, do you know where he went? Like, or some shit like yeah, some Dora Explorer type shit, dude.
I love that shit.
You know, one thing we never really talk about with the show is like kind of the cinematography of the show. Like, true. They do some pretty cool shit in there. Like the way like certain scenes, like the character would be kind of like to the bottom left of the screen, and you can kind of see everything that's happening in the background. Like, a lot of shit's pretty fucking cool what they do.
So a lot of the Sam Ismail, the creator of the show and sometimes director of a couple episodes, he talks about his influences, and mainly which is David Fincher, or Seven in particular. And if you watch the movie Seven, it does mm-hmm. similar shots like that, where the main focus of a character is not the center of the screen.
Yeah.
They're like in weird positions. Also, like, scenes that give really a lot of knowledge, they're in the back. The main character is in the background. Mm-hmm. We have this huge wide shot of an open room, especially with Angela when she's talking to the CEO. We get this vast like room, and we see them as like little people in the back mm-hmm. as they discuss big things.
God damn, we went into cinematography shit. Yeah. All right,
there's a lot of whispering in that show too.
All right, let's switch gears a little bit. Kronos, I heard you have some feelings about Konami's Metal Gear Zombie game.
Man. These motherfuckers, people are tripping balls off this fucking game. It's a goddamn shit show on YouTube, man. It's got more hate than fucking Ghostbusters. I'm like, damn, for real? I was like, how the fuck this happened? People are so mad that Kojima was not part of this project. They're just instantly shitting all over it, and they're not paying attention to the game at all. Some of their chief complaints is that it's not an infiltration, a tactical espionage game, and that Kojima, or basically that's it, is that it's not a tactical espionage game, and it doesn't feel like that at all, blah, blah, blah. But from the original videos look great to me, and then I watched the gameplay videos, both in Japanese and then in English, so I can fucking understand what the hell we're talking about. And it looks great. I don't know what the fuck people are tripping about. Like, seriously, it looks good. They were complaining about no infiltration. However, there is. Like, the video that I saw, it was a co-op, a team of four, and they had to infiltrate a base, and then they had to basically kill these zombies quietly to get into the base, and then once they got in, they just murdered them all. And after they did that, they had to start some, like, wormhole thing. And then a horde of zombies came after them. And they had to build up defenses and, like, use crafting to, like, build different defenses and shit. It looked pretty fucking cool, but people were just hating all over it. They were like, zombies don't fit in a Kojima game. Bitch, they were literally in the last game Kojima made, so yeah. Shut the fuck up.
Weren't they, like, the Black Skulls or something like that?
Yeah, well, in the Black Skulls, they made, like, the mist or whatever, made all people into actual zombies.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, your boy Kojima commented on the release of this game.
Yeah, fuck him. Yeah. Well, I'll say it, fuck him. I mean,
what do you think?
I love his games. I love the guy, but I mean, for him to shit on this other thing, I get it. You know, that was his baby. Guess what? You quit. You left your IP behind. There ain't shit you can do about it. That's them's the breaks.
Yeah. I think Kojima might have forgot that he had zombies in it, but he said if he made the game, it'd have mechs.
What? Well, yeah, but this is the thing, is that people want to complain about zombies. However, there were already zombies in the game. There were mechs that moved like fucking cows that had feet like fucking people.
Yeah.
There was all kind of crazy shit in that fucking... In all their games. They had vampires. Nobody fucking complained. They had motherfucker. They had chicks breathing through her skin. People that were undead. Nobody gave a fuck. That fucking cybernetic dudes with white blood and shit. Nobody mm-hmm. fucking cared. All of a sudden, they make things that are just like... Basically, it's like MGO, but better.
Yeah.
And they complain about it. You can go fuck yourself.
Can I just say this? Really, what the internet needs to get over is that we don't know what happened between Hideo and Konami. It obviously was a bad breakup. This was a divorce that...
Black blood.
Yeah, that got really, really ugly.
Mm-hmm.
But it's over. And so, from a gamer consumer standpoint, if this is a good game, I'm going to buy it and love it.
Uh-huh.
I love Dying Light, you know, when the Dead Island games work, I'm down with it. Left 4 Dead. Meaning, if there's a good zombie game with co-op in it, I'm going to play it and enjoy it.
Yeah.
I'll wait until the final product is out, you know, because, you know, sometimes you can't be fooled. But so far, it does look interesting. It looks like something I would play.
Is the whole gameplay just zombies, or is it like there's human aspects too? Like, is it like
as far as right outbreak? Now, it looks like zombies, yeah. Because you're basically you're in a different universe. And people are just like, oh, there was a different universe. Yeah, there was a different universe in fucking Metal Gear Solid 5 Phantom Pain. Yep. Shut the fuck up. All right, we already know this. Like, I wonder if these people that are complaining never played the game.
Yeah.
Or they're just bitching about shit. They're just selectively forgetting about the last game.
Yeah.
Well, remember with Metal Gear Solid 5, there's still bitch-made motherfuckers complaining about Quiet.
Yeah.
Who,
fuck them.
Who didn't understand, and we talked about this a billion times, her attire was explained in part of the gameplay.
Yeah.
So, you know what's kind of interesting? I just learned this the other day. You know Starfire, right? From the Teen Titans?
Hell fucking yeah.
You know how she wears skimpy clothes, right?
No, I don't. Tell
she
me.
Wears she absorbs sunlight like Superman. That's how she gets her powers.
Okay.
So that's
okay.
The reason why she wears skimpy clothes, because she needs sunlight to fucking like live. So
even with that, I don't need an excuse on somebody wearing a skimpy outfit. The main character in the game wore skin tight clothes the entire fucking time and nobody complained about shit.
Yep. Yeah, true.
Yep.
A lot of fucking video games are that way. The character wears skin tight clothes for the male cast.
Yeah, and nobody says anything.
She's still, we've said this before, the best non-playable character in video game history.
Mm-hmm.
So, Waifu Sniper Quiet was just everything. I love that game.
They need to have her in her own game.
Yeah, I'd love for her to be a playable character, because she just wrecked shit.
Yeah,
she was dope. I always every time you say that, I always think about the Mass Effect characters, because some of them are pretty... pretty dope. And you loved using Krogans.
I love, don't get me wrong, I love the Krogans, but what you could do with them in like 2 and 3 versus what Quiet brought to this game, it's night and day difference, man.
Yes. And then,
one shot, motherfuckers.
Yeah, and then the same thing about Last of Us.
Yeah, so, but here's the clarification, and we always get into this. I love The Last of Us. That's a 10 out of 10 game. However, Ellie is not a goddamn non-playable character. Obviously, what that tells me is these stupid motherfuckers did not finish the game.
Oh, yeah, it's true.
Ellie actually has her own DLC. That's nothing but her, and you play as her for literally
one level.
Literally like 2 or 3 missions, though. Mm. So, miss me with that bullshit. It tells me you didn't play the game. She's not non-playable character.
Yeah, you do play with her, but it's definitely for a really short time.
That's so. Like with like the fucking the Arkham games fucking DLCs, how they had like mini missions for unplayable characters. I mean, Robin or Nightwing you can play as, but like it was so goddamn short. Like, why you just fucking have it?
Sometimes you
put
want
in
more.
The game.
Yeah,
sometimes
actually, you can play. More. I think you can play with all the characters in the DLC, or at least was it the AR challenges? You can be anybody.
Yeah, in AR challenges you could.
And I loved from the Arkham games, playing as Catwoman felt way different.
It is. It's supposed to.
Not as bad as the last one. The last one was better though.
Yeah,
well, as far as playing as Catwoman.
I'm just saying she was faster, which you wanted. You know what I mean? But she wasn't as durable.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. You got anything else with gaming?
There's some stuff with gaming. So, what was it? Rise of Iron, the third year DLC for Destiny came out. Old Ninja was playing the other day. Actually, I was playing with...
Hold on. So, Old Ninja, what's the tally now on how much fucking that game goddamn cost?
So,
I mean, seriously.
So, I'll put it this way. If you bought the Taken King, which has all the previous DLC you can get for $20, and then
wait, motherfucker. That retail game was $60 goddamn motherfucking dollars.
So, if you buy the Taken... I'm talking about now. You can't rewind the tape now. If you buy it now, it's like $20, and then you get the DLC for another $30.
Cardo's got like a vein popping out of his head.
This game costs, I think, over $200 now.
If you bought it day one, then you probably spent $200.
What the fuck is wrong with society today? This is totally acceptable to you for a game to cost $200 fucking? $200.
Don't shrug your shoulders, motherfucker.
I mean,
it still isn't finished.
No, it's finished now.
No, I mean, I'm gonna go back and play it a little bit more, but there's still where's Mercury?
They put in Mercury. So Mercury's multiplayer. You've been able to play Mercury ever since day one.
But it's not. But it's not
part of the mission. Yeah, but it is multiplayer. Play on Mercury in the multiplayer.
That's bullshit.
Listen. All of us wanted to love this game.
It's still, you know what? It's a really good multiplayer game, and there's a ton of people playing. When I was playing when it dropped, I actually had to wait in a queue because the servers were, like, overloaded.
I believe you. There are passionate fans. There's no doubt about it.
Millions of fans.
I'm okay with everything you said. My biggest issue from a gaming consumer standpoint is I got fucking hoodwinked.
So if you bought it day one, yes. But if you're just getting, if you don't have it, your best bet is to buy it now. You can get the Taken King version for like $20-$30 and then buy the DLC now. You spend $60 on a complete game. So there's, if you like were deterred from it from the beginning, from all the negative stuff, buy it now. Buy the Taken King version. Don't buy the vanilla version. Buy the DLC now, and you'll be perfectly fine. There's plenty of content to
How
keep
about
you plenty.
This is give me.
Yeah, this is unprecedented amount of like whoring a game out. Unprecedented. Seriously, over $200.
It's like World of Warcraft, basically.
Yeah, I was about to.
Hold on. World of Warcraft, though, they do gigantic changes, and this World of Warcraft is like that's old as fuck.
Yeah,
so like it's every like couple of years they have a major update that's worth paying for. They have things that literally change everything in the fucking game.
So it's like a brand new game.
Yeah, and also graphical improvements, shit like that. No one on the level of fucking Destiny.
Well, no, because have you played The Taken King?
Not yet.
Because that changed the game fundamentally. Where everything was different. If you have not played in the last year or so...
So landscapes everywhere are different.
Yes. Well, no, not landscapes graphically. But far as gameplay mechanics and like your consumables and everything, all that's different. Completely different.
Look, World of Warcraft, they added in new playable races. They added in things that changed the entire landscapes for pretty much everywhere. They added in new whole locations that were gigantic. They added in like a whole bunch of shit that was well worth paying for.
So yeah, there are new locations that are specifically
like,
big.
Like one at a time, though.
Yeah. So like when you get... Big. So like... Well, no. The Dreadnought is pretty fucking big. And the new area, I'm barely discovering. I mean, it came out last night. Well, so there's a lot of shit that I'm still trying
to... It's kind of hard to kind of compare World of Warcraft to Destiny, because World of Warcraft is kind of a... It's kind of a... It's a top-down. So they're not using that much graphics and processor. Whereas with Destiny, you got
multiplayer. This is a first-person shooter.
And stuff, and...
Let's be careful.
Graphics and backgrounds and depth of fields.
Let's be real careful, because Destiny was touted as the first really big console MMO. That bullshit before it came out? That's the category it wanted to be in. Obviously, the big haymaker when it comes to MMOs is World of Warcraft. Yes, there's differences. No doubt about it. World of Warcraft is fantasy, all that stuff. This is a first-person shooter. But they're both supposed to be MMOs. I keep saying this over and over again. The original game for Destiny, I beat in 4 fucking hours.
Yeah.
What in the shit was that? That pissed me off.
Yep.
And that's not an MMO.
Right.
I understand they've improved it. I believe they've improved it. That's not an MMO.
That's like a $20 game.
Yes.
Yeah.
Seriously. That's the thing.
But if you went to it now, like, it would take you literally months to, like, do everything.
But we financed them to do that.
Yeah. That's what I gave them $60. I pre-ordered and got paid $60 for that. All I'm saying is, and I think from a consumer standpoint, they should have released, in my opinion, Taken King for free based on the false bullshit that they put out at launch.
Well, Taken King should have been Destiny, because then that would have been months of content.
A lot of people said
that. It didn't work out that way. They fucked up, but you know, some of us got fucked out of, you know, cash or whatnot. But I mean, it is still at its core, it's still a great multiplayer game.
You apologist, motherfucker.
No, I mean, I still play the game because it's still fun and interesting, and there's just ton of shit to do, especially with the last two DLCs.
It's greed, though. That's the main reason why I stopped playing the game, because it's total greed. It's very anti-gamer, I think. Actually, I know it's very anti-gamer, especially for gamers that are on a budget. It's basically just telling them, fuck you, we're gonna make a game and half finish it, and we're gonna make the consumers pay to finish it. And it still, as far as I'm concerned, is not complete. I mean, they're working on it, but it should not cost that much money for one fucking game that you cannot squeeze out 50 hours of like story gameplay.
That's important.
You know what a lot of people should do is if they do decide they want to try playing Destiny, they should definitely hook it up, look up on GameFly and get it that way.
There you go.
Yeah, there you go. If you want to play with the new stuff, you got to pay for that.
But I mean, here's the thing too. We all love, and I mean, I love some RPGs, some action RPGs or whatever. The Witcher is huge, and I've logged, I don't know, 80 plus hours into that game. I haven't even touched the DLCs, and supposedly those are bigger than the main campaign. So I mean, there's a precedent, a new precedent now, especially with this console generation, of giving more to consumers, especially when it's supposed to be a large open world game.
Well, now with the hardware power, they're able to do more, not just give more, because...
Same hardware power from launch with Destiny to Taken King.
No.
You on that bullshit,
no, 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 no. Compared to last generation...
Okay, all right.
As compared to now, yes, they're able to... The hardware specs from the PS4 versus PS3 is totally different. So now they're able to deliver more. Bigger, better looking, that
but
kind of thing.
But it still looks the same, though, on the PS4. It still looks exactly the same.
Yeah, unfortunately.
He's always apologizing. Always,
yeah, because I was like, well, I mean, you got to think. This was like one of the... when it first came out, it was on the PS3, and they didn't really do anything to change...
It was on both. Come on,
yeah,
now.
Well, yeah, it was on both.
It was on everything when it came out.
I'm a gaming purist. Back in the day, there was fucking shareware.
Yeah.
And they would give you... I remember getting Doom on disc. Ooh. On like a floppy drive or a floppy disc. And
like
then
fucking 18 of them.
Yeah, I would get it, install it, and then I would give it to my friends, and they would install it, and eventually when they had a new game that came out, I paid for it because it was fucking great. And they didn't cheat their consumers out of anything. They wanted to give the best product they could give to the consumer so they keep buying their product. It's all backwards now, where they put the onus on the goddamn consumers to first put the money on the game so they could continue making the game. I don't know how the fuck they got confused. That's the reason why they have pre-orders, so they can see, they basically finance the rest of the game, and it's all fucked up.
But dude, this isn't an independent studio. This isn't small time bullshit.
They have budgets.
They have huge, this is Bungie, right?
Yeah.
It's Bungie.
Bungie and Activision.
You don't get any fucking bigger besides Rockstar, you know? I mean, there's no excuse. There's no excuse. But I do hear you, old ninja. I believe, because I've heard it from a lot of people, that it is a better game after The Taken King and beyond. I hear you. It's just a day, a dollar short, day late, whatever the fuck. You know. All right. What else should we get into? What was this Corey Feldman bullshit?
Oh, my fucking God, dude.
What was this? Set us up.
So, Corey Feldman, if you know who he is, he's the guy from Lost Boys and the Corey Feldman show, or the Corey and Corey show or something like that, some reality show. But, yeah, he has an album coming out, and he was on the Today Show, I want to say. And he kind of did one of his songs from the show. And
hold on. When he says songs, he uses the term loosely.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck this shit was, but this guy was high on some because the way he was dancing and twitching and shit like that didn't make any kind of goddamn sense. He looked like a white girl who couldn't dance trying to dance like Michael Jackson.
What?
Because that's the only impression I got. He was trying to impersonate.
Like moonwalking and bullshit?
Yes.
God damn.
Crotch grabbing, twirling, fucking trying to pop lock. It was so fucking bad and so awkward to watch. I felt bad for him.
Yeah, the music was garbage. And like all the, he had female angels, but I'm pretty sure one of them was a transsexual.
Whoa.
Yeah.
All right, that's progressive.
Yeah. I'm just saying.
Yeah, all right.
But it was like, it was super fucking weird. Like him like dancing around like all awkwardly and like them singing some bullshit. And
did
like,
he have music back in the day though?
No.
I don't remember him being a star. Or
he came out looking kind of like Michael Jackson and a vampire kind of fucked and had a baby or something. I don't know. It was like super weird. God.
But he always had that Michael Jackson because him and MJ used to hang out and stuff like that. So yeah, he had like a jacket and a whole long hair.
Was he a child at the time?
Yes, he was.
He was in his teens. Yeah, I guess so.
Not a good look. All right.
Yeah, but it was really weird. So if you haven't seen it yet, definitely go check that shit out because it's pretty fucking funny to watch.
It sounds fucking embarrassing, man.
It was awful.
Is it all cringy worthy, basically?
Yeah, we'll watch it again. It's just like, it's so bad.
Yeah, it's really freaking bad.
Fucking shit.
So, Prodigy.
Yeah.
My friend Kyle, who I used to do jiu-jitsu with, who's just had back surgery a while ago, second back surgery. So, yep. Hope you get well soon, man. Get back on the mats. He had a question for you because we were talking about Cthulhu last episode.
Who he turned his back on.
Yeah, and he was, yeah. No shit. And he was asking if you knew that H.P. Lovecraft was racist as fuck.
I do know, and I'm fully aware of that. first and foremost, and I think I've mentioned this before on the cast.
We talked about this privately.
Oh, okay. So I can separate. He has some terrible things to say about black people and terrible things to say in general about people of other races.
Exactly. Who are you talking about?
H.P. Lovecraft is the author of several horror horror novels, mm-hmm. including he created Cthulhu.
Okay.
And so, yeah, he has some terribly racist, awful things. If you look up some of his quotes, it's...
Quotes? He's written stuff.
Yeah, fine. Well, the quote... You gotta, yeah.
Yeah, he's written a whole, like, prose about darkies.
Yeah, he said some terrible things.
In fact, he's written a... I don't know if this is... I think this is a short story. He written a prose or short story called On the Creation of Niggers.
Oh, yeah.
Goddamn.
It's a poem.
Yeah, it's all fucked up and terrible at the same time. I love the characters that he's created. You know, I love horror as a genre, and some of the monsters and creatures that he's made out of his head. So I could separate things that he did that were awful or said that were awful from the art, which is complicated for some people, but I don't see a problem in liking a character that a very racist person created.
So, you know what's funny? This reminds me of the Dave Chappelle skit where they had, like, where he was the Klansman.
Oh, yeah.
And they said they said he was too important to the cause. They didn't want to, he was blind. They didn't want to tell him that he was black.
Yeah, there you go.
It was pretty funny.
So, hopefully that answers it, you know?
Yeah, thanks. I think it did.
Cool. Let's appreciate it. Let's switch. What is this bullshit on In-N-Out?
Yeah. Actually, it was something that Gion had on his page. He shared out something that said that people were demanding, they were signing petitions to get In-N-Out to have vegetarian options. To which case I say, I hope that, you know what they should do? They should get the names and addresses of everybody that's on the petition list and then send them a bag of dicks. Like, how fucking dare you try to get, if I can't get bacon on my goddamn double-double, fuck you and your vegetarian options. Yeah. Right? What the fuck? I don't go into vegan or vegetarian restaurant and demand a fucking real bacon or some kind of meat. So leave your plant-based bullshit outside of a burger joint.
You know what's
I don't want mashed together fucking vegetables between some fucking bun and shit.
You know what's ironic, though? You can get a grilled cheese there.
You can, but they just complain that it's not enough.
And you can eat french fries.
Yeah.
They don't have any fucking meat on them. What in the fuck is wrong with these people?
They're stupid as fuck.
And I think they cook their french fries in vegetable oil, too, so it's vegan friendly, I guess?
Yeah, you will fine. Say? Yeah. You know?
Like, they cook other stuff inside the grease. It's just fucking fries.
Like, literally, In-N-Out would have to get a whole new grill in every single one of the locations to cook vegan stuff on there.
And they don't know them shit.
No.
They don't know them a goddamn thing.
Let's just call them for what they are. Eco-terrorists.
Oh! Yeah.
Well, I remember, like, people were fucking complaining that fucking Starbucks, a lot of their drinks aren't fucking vegan-friendly.
Like, they have milk. So what?
Well, not just because they have milk, but, like, some of the red dye they use for, like, their strawberry-flavored whatever is, like, some kind of meat or a bug. It's made from a bug. They use that for making the color, so people are complaining about that shit, so...
Don't drink it, then.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I mean, that's a simple answer.
It's not good for you anyway.
Yeah.
So, I love that joke by, what's that guy's name? It totally slipped my mind, but he talked about how, like, you know, he hates when he has vegan people come over to his house for a barbecue, and they're like, hey, you know, how come you haven't made no meat for me, or no vegetarian stuff for me? And he's like, well, if I go to your fucking house, you're gonna have a fucking T-bone steak for me? I'm like, hey, I don't want my meat to touch that goddamn gross vegetable shit.
Yeah, it's so ridiculous. They're so demanding of people that eat everything like you're supposed to. You're supposed to be an omnivore. Like, we can scientifically talk about this if you want, and you'll lose. I mean, that's the reason why we have sharp front teeth.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, we're predators. That's the reason why our eyes face forward. We have no problem digesting meat. Like, these are not problems. I'm like, back if we didn't eat meat, we would not have survived.
Yeah.
Like, people don't seem to understand that.
Well, even vegans that don't eat meat, they have to, like, find other sources to get, like, the vitamins that they need that they should be getting from meat.
Like, B12 super hard to fucking find in vegetables, mm-hmm. especially the amount you have to eat iron, shit like that. It's difficult to find, but people want to argue that you can live fine on a vegan or vegetarian diet. And don't get me wrong, there's some folks, a very, very small subset, are genetically predisposed to doing well on a vegetarian or vegan diet. But guess what? That's a very small percentage of the population. The rest of us have to eat like omnivores the way that we're genetically, you know, disposed to doing. We're supposed to eat meat and vegetables. So,
and fucking vegans have some stanky ass forks, dude.
Yeah.
I had a vegan roommate, and man, he slowly blow that shit up.
They're slowly fucking dying. That's why. That's why most of them don't even survive their vegan diet for that long. It's like a couple years, and then they end up getting real sick, and then their doctor's like, "What the fuck are you doing?"
Well, and has In-N-Out gave in to their fucking bullshit?
No, they're not going to. Yeah. They didn't give in the bake request.
There you go.
Because if they cave, then they're going to try to get Burger King and like McDonald's to cave. I mean, the only thing is Burger King, McDonald's, they offer salads, but like In-N-Out, they don't have to conform to what you want, because you know why? There are alternatives you can go to eat. So go somewhere with your feelings.
Every fast food restaurant, for the most part, has a salad and, you know, all kinds of vegetarian options. So whatever.
Yeah, that's what I don't get. It's just like there's already so many options out there for you.
There's more McDonald's and Burger Kings than there are In-N-Out burgers.
Or you could just not eat fast food because it's not good for you. If you want to be healthy, then stop going to fucking In-N-Out. What the hell is wrong with you?
Yeah.
Well, because I know there's like a study that says like for example, like a McDonald's salad is actually more calories than the Big Mac, but that's if you add like meat and fucking sauce and stuff like that. But if you're just eating fucking green vegetables, I guess it's kind of healthy.
The thing for me though is that when people say stuff like that, it's like, vegetables have calories too. And if you're telling me that vegetable calories are the same as French fry calories or a fucking, you know, American cheese calories, then you're fucking stupid. You know, it's like you're probably much better off eating a 1,000-calorie salad than you are eating a 1,000-calorie hamburger.
That's true.
Let's be honest here.
All
right, let's go back one sec to something with in the comic world. Speaking of dumbasses on online, Shia LaBeouf.
Oh yeah.
People are signing petitions, I guess, online because they want him to play the Red Hood. Holy fuck.
Who?
Yeah, I don't understand who's doing. Blue, can you explain it? You are a Batman expert. What the fuck?
I don't know who they are either. It ain't me. Let me see. I saw it on comicnews.com, and they had mentioned that the other
comic news.
News. N-E-S-N-E-W-S. But people are actually petitioning to try to get him to do it. The reason why, I have no clue, but it's kind of out there right now. I'm trying to look up the article.
Well, that's a hard no.
I don't respect him as an actor.
Not anymore.
I mean, he's a great meme and gif, don't get me wrong. When he's saying, you know, just do it and all that other stuff, that's hilarious. But, I mean, the motherfucker's gone crazy ever since, what was it, Transformers 3? Whatever the fuck it was, a few years back.
I don't know.
Or no, 2, because he wasn't in 3.
Yeah, 2, but nobody even respected him as an actor beforehand.
No, he was, I mean,
as an actor.
As an actor, a lot of people did respect him because he brought the chops. I mean, the last thing he did,
chops? Can you define chops?
Yeah, in the acting world, they talk about bringing acting chops. It's basically acting skills. He does have, if you've ever seen the Lars von Trier's Nymphomaniac, part 1 and 2.
You always name it the most obscure shit ever.
So that movie is supposed to be really good.
Wait, did you watch it?
Not yet. This is my cue.
Well, have you guys seen Fury?
What I've heard. Wait, what?
The movie Fury with the
Oh, I did see Fury.
Yeah, he was in that.
He is in that. He's like,
it's a World War II movie, right?
Yeah, yes, him and, about the tanks and stuff.
So,
and
hold on. Is he good in it or not?
Yeah, he's good in it.
How do you know?
Because I've seen it.
Oh, wait, which one are you talking about?
Fury.
Oh.
So he's good in that.
He's good in that.
Brad Pitt's in it, that's right.
Well, it's Brad Pitt, the kid who plays Percy Jackson.
This is an actor who's been in at least a dozen and a half films.
He was good in Disturbia.
Okay, and you're naming 2 films that you're saying he's good at.
Hoes. Talked about that a little bit earlier.
Let's put you guys on the motherfucking spot.
Even Steven?
I think you're saying he's good in it because we're asking right now. I don't think... I don't think while watching it or right afterwards, you said to yourself, wow, Shia LaBeouf was great in that film.
He hasn't gotten any awards that I'm aware of. I don't put him on a level of like a Denzel or anybody.
Has he been nominated for shit?
No, I know of.
Fact checked it.
11. He's won 11 awards and he's been nominated for 38.
Oh, Teen Actor Awards?
Yeah, whatever.
So he was nominated. Really? He was nominated for Best Supporting Actor in Indiana Jones.
Oh, my God.
An Academy Award.
Holy shit.
I don't know.
Are you serious?
Oh, no. Saturn Award. Sorry. Saturn Award.
Where's your glasses at? No.
God, I'm reading the wrong
old
thing.
Nigga, you getting old.
I'm Holy reading, shit. It's the setup here.
Yeah, whatever, motherfucker.
So he's been nominated for, like, a couple things, like a Hollywood Film Award.
How many wins does he have?
Let's see.
Keep looking.
So the reason why people are saying that he's the most talented actor in Hollywood right now,
Are you shitting me?
Wait, what? Fuck? No, he's not the most talented actor.
Yeah, okay, let's all be casting directors for a second. I would want someone like Stephen Amell, who plays Arrow. I think he'd be a great Red Hood.
Yeah, he would, but he's already the Arrow.
Yeah, I hear you, but I'm just saying, his look and, you know what I mean? I mean, he's a big guy, he lifts, he's strong, he can act. I think he would be great. Who would you guys pick?
Shit, that's too soon.
As Red Hood?
I would make Red Hood maybe black and have it be the guy who played Creed.
Oh, wow, you're going Michael B. Jordan?
Yeah, I might see
him. You're going to change his race, too?
Yep, I'm going to change his race.
Wow.
That's the only person I can think of that's, like, fit and stuff like that.
He is fit.
Who can, like, probably take that mantle and fucking be a badass.
Fuck that. It's going to be a black actor. Let's get Shamir up in there.
Well, Shamir Anderson, yes, from Winona Earp. Nice.
Let's get that dude paid.
Yes, he does want to be in films, comic book films. What you got, old ninja?
I don't even know. Like, I can't think of anyone that... I can't think of anyone they would be scouting for that would fit that description.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of like a young white male actor that would know how to kick ass. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
I'm coming up with a blank right now.
Me too. That's why I went change the color for a little bit.
What about Daenerys's love on Game of Thrones that she curved?
I think he's too old.
Yeah, he's too old.
Too old? Okay. Yeah. I mean, Red Hood wears the mask a lot, though, right?
Yeah, but he'll take it off at some point, though.
Yeah.
You know? See, I would kind of put Kit Harington there. But I think he might be a little too old.
Oh, Jon Snow?
Yeah. I think he could work.
You know what?
I don't think it could work.
I don't mind that one. I don't mind that one at all. He can't sell me a fucking Infinity, though. I was like, you know nothing, motherfucker. And he looks the same.
No, he needs to sell death is what he needs to do. Like, trying to sell cars and shit. Like, get your ass back to the north. You got shit to do.
I didn't buy that for a fucking second, man.
Maybe the kid who plays Percy Jackson. But
he's actually older.
His name's Logan. Lerman.
What about the one that was in the movie with Al Pacino, Bad Grandpa?
Zac Efron?
Zac Efron?
Fuck that guy.
I mean,
maybe.
Nah.
That dude skips leg day.
Yeah.
But he's yoked as fuck.
He's ripped. He looks like he can, hold his own. At least, on a Hollywood set.
Now, we should ask, Earth Girls Are Easy, because they know all the fucking hot dudes are and shit.
They do.
Ladies, if you could answer, who would play a good Robin? Or we'll just say Robin for now.
Say Robin.
Like an older Robin.
A Robin that becomes Jason, that becomes Red Hood.
But if we say Red Hood, they don't know who the fuck we're talking about.
Yeah. Okay.
So we're just going to say a grown-up Robin. Who should it be? We're talking about like mid-20s Robin.
Oh, you know what? There's another thing that goes along with the Robin stuff, and that's the actor, I forget his name, who plays, you guys saw Big Hero 6, right?
Yeah.
There's an actor that was the voice of Hero from Big Hero 6 that wants to play Robin in the Batman solo Ben Affleck movie.
Okay.
Asian actor. I don't know his name, but he's been trying to show off his fighting skills and just kind of some short vids and whatnot.
Wait, he was the voice of who?
Hero.
Ryan Potter.
Sound Asian.
That's
at all.
His name.
All right. Is he an Asian actor?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You said it didn't sound Asian.
His name's Ryan Potter.
Ryan Potter? I mean, I thought he had a, an ethnic name.
Yeah, it is ethnic. It's just the wrong... Yes.
Actually, you know what? There's someone who's been promoting to be, like, Robin. Basically, another DC character. Even he plays Firestorm on Flash and Arrow. Robbie Amell. I think he could work that out.
Yeah.
I can see that.
There's a lot. Shia LaBeouf is shit, man. I'm just saying.
I think Shia LaBeouf could pull it off. But he would need to work out a little bit.
A lot of it. Yeah. All right.
And he can't say fucking no. Have you seen that video? There's a video
on
YouTube.
He does in Transformers.
In every movie he's been in, he shout no like a bunch of fucking times. Like all of them, he's pretty much said it like crazy. Yeah. Definitely check that shit out.
Holy fucking shit. Did anybody check out South Park came back on?
I didn't watch it this week.
Ooh.
Man.
Wait, to jump back. Back on the Robin thing. So we have Matt from Prereq Live. He thinks that Josh Hartnett, if he was a little younger, would have been a good Red Hood.
I'm down with that. He's a 40-plus-year-old guy now, right?
Yeah, but that's a great pick, actually, Matt. And then he said the kid who played Daredevil, the young Matt Murdock, the one when he had his accident from season one, could be young Robin.
Perhaps, perhaps.
But I think you might be a little too young.
If I can go back in fucking time, I'd actually take Keanu.
All right, hold on. Let's, real quick, hold on.
What you got?
This is what Blue was talking about.
What you got?
Watch.
What?
You playing something on YouTube? Oh, Transformers. Just no, no, no,
no. No, 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 no!
Oh, no, no, no.
No, 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 no.
No, 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 no.
No, 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 no.
This is Shia LaBeouf.
No, 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 no,
no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, oh, no,
this is just all in one movie.
Yeah,
oh no 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 no!
Even
no,
a Penguin movie.
No 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 no
I'll disturb you.
No 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 no
no. Yeah, that's hilarious.
Oh, that Asian kid, he would be good at Jason Todd.
Yeah,
that's pretty funny.
Okay, yeah, he says no a lot, man.
Yeah, he does.
That's your boy.
No, 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 no. I can imagine that as fucking the Joker's fucking smashing in his fucking face with the crowbar.
Dude, I would love to see that scene live action played out, man.
Yeah, it'd be brutal.
That would be wonderful.
Under the Hood is still a really good fucking animated movie.
That's, to me, I'm going to say that's my favorite.
Yeah, it's still my favorite.
I love the stuff with Damien as well, and Damien's hit or miss. Like, some people hate him, but that Under the Hood, Red Hood is...
You know the kid at
Cake Man chimed in.
What'd he say?
He said the guy who played Quicksilver... Or he's also Kick-Ass from...
You know what?
Yeah, I was thinking that too, but they're kind of old. Even when I say Kick-Ass, but they're like kind of older now.
No, are we talking about for Young Robin or for Red Hood?
Red Hood, yeah, still be good.
Yeah, Aaron Taylor Thomas, yeah, that's his name.
That's actually
Australian, I think, British or Australian or something.
I think we got at least four or five potential
good candidates.
Yeah.
I was going to say, like, the guy from Hero, the one of the brothers, the one that could absorb other people's powers. I think what
yeah, I remember you talk about
like,
him.
Like, I thought of him maybe as being...
Milo. Milo, yeah.
He had a good look.
Yeah.
All right, South Park, back on. I'm loving this show, man.
Oh, yeah, it was funny what they did with Colin Kaepernick and the whole thing. That shit was hilarious. The new national anthem, that shit was great.
Well, and they also brought these things back called member berries.
Yeah, that shit was so funny.
And you have to see the episode, but basically they're like grapes that talk and say, remember Chewbacca? Remember R2-D2? And it all just talks about stuff you can feel nostalgia about, and it was just great, man.
Isn't that a skit from somewhere?
I don't know. If so, I hadn't seen it. But the other thing that they did was, not too subtly, they made fun of, at least in my mind, Amy Schumer, you know, and some of her brand of comedy, and I was like, that's great.
Yeah, yeah.
I fucking love those guys.
Well,
so.
Yeah, they probably made fun of her because recently...
Well, get on a mic, man.
Well, recently with her, she had said something about...
That mic's off.
There you go, talk now.
They were saying she was talking about how, like, girls and shit aren't, like, taken serious and stuff like that, but then, like, one of her fans came up to her and did something, and she got hella mad about it. It's like, well, you just fucking did this shit, like, last week. Like, why are you being such a... Why are you being, what is it, contradictive?
Yeah, I didn't see that, but I don't know. I've never really found her all that funny, but if she's good and stuff, I'll give her credit, you know? So we shall see. Are anybody getting this? How do you pronounce it? I always fuck this up. Deus Ex? Yeah. Anybody getting this?
I was thinking about it, and then I still have shit to play.
Okay.
So there's other games I want to play first. I just went back and started playing... Far Cry Primal.
Oh, nice. Okay.
So, yeah, I need to finish that because I have a bad habit of, like, beating a game, like, 700% and then just, like, dropping it.
Yep.
So, yeah.
And you loved that one, too. That one and Doom. Yeah. I remember you talking about it at the beginning of the year.
Back on Doom, too. Yeah.
Well, then you know The Witcher is long as fuck, and I know you're playing through that.
Yeah. And it's on hard, so it's even fucking harder.
Yeah. I told you, man. You got to go to places of power.
It's hard as fuck.
Yeah, I believe it. I want to see your gameplay
on
there.
You know what game was so hard? I just stopped playing it.
Which one?
That Neo game.
Neo game? Which one?
It was this game that's it's kind of like Dark Souls meets Ninja Gaiden.
Oh, yeah.
The game was hard as fuck. I was just playing the demo and I was like, miss me with this bullshit.
Dude, Dark Souls are for like people, those games are for people who
for
love
sadists?
Punishment. Yes. I mean, it's
or
like,
is that masochist?
Yeah, whatever, man. Those games are fucking ridiculous, man. But some people love them. So, you know, if you can beat them, great for you.
I like challenges, but right now I don't have enough time to get great at video games anymore. Yeah. I mean, I'm still pretty good, but I just don't have time to, you know.
Like master shit.
Yeah. I'm mastering other shit, like how to do podcasts. How about that?
There you go. Go ahead.
No, I was just saying there's plenty of games coming out as well. There's a whole slew of games the way out.
Fall is always the busiest time.
Yep.
And something's going to get lost in the shuffle. Just like last year. Yeah. Last year, I think the game that really took a huge hit unnecessarily, even though it was a good game that you guys have played, was Tomb Raider.
It
came out the same day as Fallout 4, and nobody fucking bought it for the most part. And it's sad.
Hilarious how there's always a game every fucking year that gets overshadowed. I remember that it was Far Cry 3 got overshadowed because it came out right at Christmas or something like that.
Yeah.
And the same thing I think with Saints Row too.
Yep.
And I was like, nobody played the game, and I was just like, what the? This game is great.
Yeah.
And nobody played it.
Actually, I haven't played this game, but I've heard it got overlooked. Was the Rainbow Six Siege? I heard that got overlooked, but yes. I know people that play it and they swear up and down that it's like one of the best shooters out there.
Then it came out. It came out the same time as what's the game we're playing? We squatted up on recently.
The Division.
Yeah, it came out the same time as The Division, right?
But there was like little to no advertisement for that game.
Yeah,
that's true.
And there hasn't been a Rainbow Six game in like years either. And I heard it's great. I know people that still play to this day.
Ghost was pretty good. Ghost Recon.
That's coming back. I can't wait. Ghost Recon's pretty dope.
Yeah, there you go.
I'm afraid that there's probably going to be a really good game that people sleep on, and it's just not.
Here's the thing. You obviously always know in the fall you're going to have a battle for which first-person shooter is going to win. This year you have Titanfall 2, you have Battlefield 1, and you have the new Call of Duty.
Yeah, Infinite Warfare.
So that's already a tight space.
Yeah, I don't know if it's coming out this year. Probably not. Prey 2 or the new Prey?
That's next year.
Yeah, so like any other shooter that's trying to come out in the fall might get buried.
Yeah.
That's what's kind of sad, especially even if it's good.
And all the PlayStation fans never played Tomb Raider, and that comes out in October.
And actually, PlayStation VR is coming out pretty soon, and there's a shitload of games coming out for that.
Yeah.
And I don't know how well it's going to do, but from what I've seen, it doesn't look bad.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it should be good. All the games we were talking about, there's a lot of great games coming out. You know what would be even greater? If you got Gamefly.
Look at you.
Ding!
Well, it was cool that video of, speaking of VR, the video you posted up earlier of the fucking waifu or the virtual girlfriend experience or whatever. That shit was pretty funny.
Yeah, I can't remember the name of that actual title. If you remember
it's called
that. But basically, you play, you tutor a young Japanese girl one on one.
Schoolgirl.
Yeah, Japanese schoolgirl. And she is your waifu and all that good stuff. And I mean, obviously, there's, the kind of pervy element to it.
Kind of pervy?
Just a little bit. I mean, don't judge, motherfucker. Calm down. But anyway, it looks fun in VR. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Ooh, actually, I forgot a game that's coming out that Prodigy and Old Ninja played.
Which one?
Gears of War 4.
Yeah, that's huge.
That's going to be huge.
That's a big game, man.
Because the last Gears of War came out in the 360, and it's been a few years, and there's diehard fans waiting for this game. We played it. It brought me back. I was like, damn, I miss Gears.
Fun game.
So the name of that game on PlayStation VR is called Summer Lesson.
Yeah.
And they actually announced it at the PlayStation event.
Oh, wow.
Like, there's a guy on stage playing the game in front of everybody, so, yeah.
All right. Let me switch gears. I got a surprise announcement for everybody listening in. Dun, dun, dun. So, we're going to have quite a few actors from Ash vs. Evil Dead.
Oh, shit.
On the show.
Damn.
Ash vs. Evil Dead was one of our favorite new shows from last year, season one. This is the Bruce Campbell series based off like the Evil Dead films that everybody fucking loved.
With Sam Raimi.
With Sam Raimi, yes. And we're going to have, starting with Ray Santiago coming up next week. We'll probably release it in right after the episode airs, but it's coming very, very soon, and we are super excited about that. So some more S-Class interviews coming your way, and because I'm not fucking done, we're going to give away season one to somebody on Twitter. So, we will use probably a good hashtag, a new hashtag, I love Ash versus Evil Dead, and then tweet it at us, and we'll pick somebody at random. So hashtag, I love Evil Dead, and give us your reason for why you love Ash versus Evil Dead.
No, we got to get a better one than that. Let's
Which one?
Hashtag Pillow Talk, baby.
Yeah! Oh, that's Perfect. Hashtag pillow talk baby.
So in case you didn't know, Ray played Pablo on Ash vs. the Evil Dead. He's Ash's little sidekick, what he calls him.
Yes. He's hilarious. Yeah, that guy's so fucking funny. I can't wait to talk to him.
What's this? Oh, yeah, he called him Efe.
Yeah.
So what's up, Efe? So,
hashtag pillow, what was it? Pillow talk baby.
Pillow talk baby.
Send us some tweets. And, you know, put a GIF in there, put a meme, something, and we're going to pick somebody at random and just send them season one on Blu-ray and DVD. How about that?
So Matt said it should have been hashtag Black versus Evil Dead.
Oh,
or yeah. Be Them BTI versus Evil Dead. That would have been dope.
Yeah. So, holy shit. So we're excited about both of those fucking things, just to put that fucking out there.
Yeah. All for you. And for us, too. We'll probably fangirl a little bit.
No, Stitch isn't here, but he had an Ask Be Them BTI. BTI question. You guys want to answer it or just wait till next week when he's hopefully back in here?
I want to hear what this question is. Now that you
brought it up.
No.
All right. So.
Technical difficulties. Keep going.
So his question was, so this comes from our own cast member, Stitch. He says, who do you think are the worst TV parents of all time?
Ooh.
And his answer is the dad from Radio Flyer and Tara's mom from True Blood.
Oh.
She was a bitch.
She was.
I'll have to go with Barb's parents.
From Stranger Things.
Stranger Things, from Stranger. Barb. That mom did not give a single solitary
fuck. No bucks.
Damn. Off the top, maybe because we were just talking about South Park, but Randy on South Park is pretty fucking bad, too. You know? Didn't give a single solitary fuck. Or maybe Archie Bunker. I don't know. Who you got, old ninja?
I don't even know. Who was super retarded?
Man, you put us on the spot with that one.
Yeah, good one, man.
I didn't get the prep.
So I'm going to say... For mine, it's going to be really funny, but I'm going to say fucking Batman from Bruce Wayne, because like he's a foggy father figure for a bunch of other like orphan kids that he's taken in, but he's not very affectionate, loving, and he's taking these kids out to fight crime with them, like with them all the time, where putting their life in danger. So I would say Bruce Wayne.
This is true.
And I would also say Barry Allen's father from The Flash, because he was Mr. like, I'm out of jail.
Biological dad.
Yeah, biological dad.
He was like, peace. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Oh, you're on that part now.
I'm past. I'm on season two now.
Nice. Yeah,
he was like, I need to go get some cigarettes. Right? Yeah. You just got out of jail and you're, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. That tripped me out.
Wow. There's actually a couple of them that did that. I got to say, even though I love this show, and I think you watch the show because they're bad parents, is Al Bundy and Peg Bundy.
They're terrible
parents, but the show is awesome because they're terrible parents.
Good shit.
I would have to go also with Peter Griffin.
Shut up, Meg.
Yeah, he's one of like the worst of all time. So is Homer. He's pretty bad, but Peter's got him beat though.
Peter's annoying as fuck. I can't really watch the show because of him.
He's fucking hilarious.
Goddamn. That's good shit.
It's crazy. If you go back to like season one of the show, like the way the characters are represented changed. Like before, Peter was like kind of a retard. I mean, I guess he still is a retard, but like his whole attitude has changed since the season one versus season 15 we're on or whatever.
Same with Stewie.
Yeah, Stewie too. Like his whole goal was trying to kill Lois, but now he's just like a fucking. He went from like a genius trying to kill his mom to like you don't know what his sexuality is, and him and Ryan just kind of buddying up. So it definitely changed the perspective of that show.
Oh. Cersei Lannister.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. That's a good one.
Bad parents.
From what?
From Game of Thrones.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you're the only motherfucker that don't watch that.
Hey, there's people out there that listen probably don't watch it either.
Yeah, there you go.
That's a good question.
Man, I still can't fucking wait for the shows to come back on.
Wait, you mean we have listeners that don't watch Game of Thrones?
Yeah
what's that about?
You know what we call them, listeners? Fucking awesome. Fuck Game of Thrones. Thanks for listening to us.
Damn. Thank you. Fuck. All right.
Podcast more important.
Holy shit. Okay, where are we going next? Real quick, too. We've talked a little bit about the anime on Crunchyroll, Berserk.
Oh, yeah.
Which we love. And I was curious because I was listening to the Crunchyroll official cast, and they said, there's all this history with the main character, Guts. He's missing an arm. He's missing an eye. He's obviously traumatized from some shit. So I went ahead and bought like the I guess it's a movie trilogy with Guts, and holy shit, you do learn everything about him. So I brought this over. You can see it on the YouTube feed. It's called Berserk: The Golden Age Arc. I loved it. Anime titties and sword fighting.
Awesome. Since we're on anime, can we talk about Mob Psycho 100?
Yes, please.
What the fuck is that?
Holy shit! So the guy that made One Punch Man made a new manga slash anime called Mob Psycho 100, and it is fucking hilarious.
Yep.
It's basically the guy. He's bringing my childhood back. Like it's like me as like a 10-year-old making an anime that looks awesome. Mm-hmm. That's basically what this is. It's about this kid that looks plain as fuck. That he has psychic and telekinetic powers, like to like One Punch Man degree. Mm-hmm. All right, and then there's this other guy who's like his quote unquote boss, who's quote unquote psychic, but he's not really a psychic, and he always has the kid do all like the heavy lifting. And then when the kid asks him, he just goes, "Oh, I you know that spirit or whatever was like not at you know it wasn't powerful enough for me to even you know fight. So you just go ahead and do it. You do the cleanup work." And it's so fucking funny though because hilarious. Yeah. Like him, because he has like no real emotions, but apparently he does, because like they just like build up inside, and once they build up inside enough, he goes like fucking Super Saiyan or some shit. Yeah, it's like it's really crazy.
I can already tell you right now, this is going to be, and I've only watched one episode, it's going to be on the best anime of this year.
Yeah,
it's going to be on there, at least nominated.
Would it be competing with One Punch Man, or was that last year?
That was last year.
That was last year, so we got a whole new slate this year.
Yeah, this one is just. I think One Punch Man is better, but this one's kind of funnier.
Ah, see that? That's something.
Yeah.
Where are you? Are you up episode 3?
I think I'm on like 4 or 5.
Okay.
So, yeah, that's the only reason why I know that he get like his emotions. See, you didn't notice like when you watch the anime, it's like it says like mob's level is at a certain percentage.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's like his emotional level.
Shit.
So once it gets to 100, like shit goes crazy. Oh, and it's like, dude, what the fuck just happened?
I can't wait. Yeah, I'm going to watch some more of that fucking probably this weekend.
I was watching it right now. Like the fight scenes are fucking crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm checking out the...
Oh, when he goes, his emotions go crazy?
Yeah, I'm watching the trailer for the show. The official preview on one of the other networks.
All right. Holy shit. What'd you pick up in this pool over here for comics?
I got a lot, actually, today. It's another... I think it was like almost $70 today spent on comics. The New Civil War, which is the... This is the... Black Panther variant, but it looks like also like kind of mixes Iron Man variant, like on the cover.
Oh, yeah, like his eye, yeah.
But it's really cool because at the very end, a major character dies and a major character kills him.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that's going to be interesting to see how that falls out because I think it was, I don't want to give it away.
Yeah.
So I'll just stop there. I also got, somebody talked about this at San Francisco Comic Con and they recommended Lumberjanes.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, so I picked it up. If you guys suggest things to us, we'll actually get them. So, and I'm still going to get the Fifth Estate, but I know that K-Mac got it. She wants to read it, and she has it on digital. I usually like reading. I can read digital. It's fine with like books. So I'll probably just get her account and read it off there. If I like it, then I'll buy the actual physical copy. That way, I don't feel fucking bad. Some Batman, a bunch of Rebirth shit, Invader Zim, which I always love.
Harley Quinn, what you talking about?
Injustice, Cyborg came out the actual first one. You know,
oh, not that 00 one-off bullshit.
Wait, yeah. Didn't we do that with one of our podcast?
Yeah, before.
We did like 49 00 00.
Yeah, one of for episode 49. Like it was episode 49 for like 5 episodes.
Oh, yeah, because we wanted to do something special for 50.
Yeah, yeah.
The new Power Man in Iron Fist. On the Wolverine, some Thor shit. It's like a lot. So the new Punisher series is actually pretty good. It was number 5.
Okay.
So if y'all haven't noticed, there's a new Punisher series that's out. It's pretty decent. I like it. I like the artwork as well. I think the artwork, I don't know who does the artwork, but it's good.
Same, like they haven't changed the actual Punisher, right?
No.
It's not a new person.
Just killing motherfuckers.
Yeah. Apparently.
It's still Frank Castle.
Good, okay.
The artist is Steve Dillon. I like his art style. It's pretty cool.
I need to get back into that, man, because I haven't read Punisher since I was a kid and I loved him.
Yeah, another one that people are sleeping on all the time is Venom Space Knight. Ooh. Really, really good comic. I talk about it a few times on the cast.
Mm-hmm. Is this Spider-Man's Venom?
Yes. Well, it's what's his name? Flash Thompson.
Flash Thompson.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he's the.
I mean, Venom comes from space, so.
Yeah. And then I got another one from Image. It's called Seven to Eternity. I told you every now and again I roll them dice on comics. And I like the cover of this one. It looked pretty cool. It looked like aliens and guns and shit. So I'm like, fucking, I'm in.
All right.
That's so, cool. And then I saw that it is actually getting some big, like, praise, I guess, already. So
yeah,
I'll look forward to reading it. And this is from last week, though. It's the Black Monday Murders. If you guys haven't read this yet, check it out. It's about money and how money is basically, like, money and finance is tied up with, like, aliens or some shit.
I still need to read it. Yeah, I still need to read it.
Is it like that that movie Alive with Roddy Roddy Piper?
No.
Do you remember that show?
They Live.
Oh, yeah, They Live.
It's like aliens or gods or something like that, but it's super intricate. It's a Hickman comic.
Oh, shit.
So far, it's great. Yeah, they're both, like, the first one will stick, and this one stick as fuck, too.
Yeah, that does look.
So now I'm worried that there's not going to be another one for a while, because The Dying and the Dead, where the fuck did that go, Jonathan Hickman?
Yeah.
What the fuck happened? And East to West, I don't know if you noticed, if you go on the website for Image Comics, there's no number 30.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well,
so I'm like, what the fuck is going on?
I got to read my one from last week that I pulled.
29, yeah. But I'm like, there's no number 30 that's, like, posted.
That's weird.
Yeah. I had to catch up on my comic read. I'm so fucking far behind.
Yeah, I'm pretty behind.
I finished, actually, I got to give props to one. I finished Old Man Logan number 9 or 10 or whatever with the stuff in Japan.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm loving everything about that. The art is gorgeous.
Yeah, it's weird. It's a different art style.
Yeah.
So,
but I like it.
I like it, yeah.
I really love it.
Isn't the next Wolverine movie supposed to be based off of the Old Man Logan tales?
I keep hearing that it should be.
That's what they said. It's gonna be Old Man Logan.
Okay, then they gotta do a lot to, you know, get to that point. But yeah, I want that, and it's supposed to be his last ride or whatever.
So. Yeah, I mean, he's getting old, dude. So,
well, it's funny. He's getting older, but he's more ripped than when he started.
Yeah, that's awesome, though.
So kind of like, okay, so getting back to Starfire again, like, I listened to a podcast where they go into depth about her, and one of her abilities, she has a berserker mode too, where she fucking just starts wrecking shit.
Yeah.
And like, there's not that many people who can take her out when she's in a berserker mode. Like, it takes like Superman to take her out.
She's extremely powerful.
Yeah.
Who are you talking about?
Starfire.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's good shit.
And apparently so is Raven. Actually, there was a Raven comic that came out, I believe, today.
Oh, really?
I didn't see it at the comic shop, and actually I was missing Trinity too. I didn't see at the comic shop. Maybe I didn't just notice that it wasn't there.
The Trinity is the one with Batman, Superman, and Wonder Woman, right?
Yes, I really want to pick it up. I'm going to look tomorrow for it.
Okay.
So, and then also Raven as well. I think Lily would like it because of my daughter, that's her name, because she was super emo at the beginning of
summer.
Yeah, the kid was wearing all black. I'm like, it's fucking summertime in California. What are you doing? And then, like, I actually went out and bought new clothes, and I was like, you can pick your clothes, but you ain't picking shit that's black. So,
she's all, daddy, I'm part black. Let me be me.
Holy shit. Wow. Now, did anybody actually finish off Fear the Walking Dead? We haven't talked about that in forever.
There's been some stuff on there. I ended up where there was a reveal on the show. And there's an episode after that I didn't get a chance to watch because I had to move.
Have they done anything with our boy Lincoln?
I haven't seen him yet.
No, I haven't seen him yet. But there's been some stuff about possibly surviving the infection.
Ooh.
After being bit.
Okay.
So, I mean, there is. You get your fucking arm chopped off.
There's a character on the show who was bit and still managed to survive.
Oh. So they're still working their way through season 2, though, right?
Yes, they are. I think it ends next week or something like that. It should end, like, usually the week before, but I think it's ending sooner.
And then we get no Walking Dead for, like, a few weeks.
Until October.
So, like, a month.
It's like two weeks.
Well, yeah, it comes out in 5 weeks from today.
Okay.
They posted that up today on AMC's website.
God damn, I can't wait for Walking Dead to come back on.
Yeah, it's going to be, you know, that's probably going to be the highest rated cable show or cable viewing in, like, history.
I wouldn't be surprised if they get, like, a Guinness Book World Record for being, like, the highest viewing ship on the fucking...
Because everybody wants to know who's going to die.
Well, and you know what? I can already tell you, they're not going to tell you on that first episode.
I thought about them doing that.
They're going to tease it out to episode 2.
It's probably going to be a huge flashback fucking episode, and everyone's going to be fucking mad.
Yep, and they're not going to give a single solitary fuck.
You know, I'd be pissed if they... I mean, if they do that, I think they would do, a little bit of a backstory of Negan.
Yeah, that's what I would imagine.
Like, the first few episodes would be, like, where Negan came from and
you know what?
Upcoming.
I wouldn't be surprised if they just focus on Morgan and those two guys that he saw.
They could.
There's probably going to be a huge Morgan-centric episode.
Yep, I could actually already see
It'll be Morgan, the two dudes, and then Carol. And then that'll probably be the opening. and everyone's gonna be like, who? Everyone's gonna be screaming, who dies? Who dies?
Holy, it's gonna be crazy. Fucking, and nobody better ruin that bullshit online or whatever.
No, you know it's gonna happen. East Coasters are gonna be posting.
They better
hard.
Not. Fucking hate that, man.
Did any of you guys watch the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.?
I didn't get a chance to, no.
I saw Twitter explode about Ghost Rider, but I didn't watch it. Go ahead.
I'm not going to go too much into it, but that whole scene with Ghost Rider is pretty fucking dope. And there's a fight scene. I guess this is a little bit of a spoiler, but it's the first 5 minutes of the show. You know something's going to happen. But there's a fight between Ghost Rider and Davey or Quake.
Oh, wow.
And it's
okay.
A pretty good fight scene because she's been trained by the Asian chick. I can't remember her name. Agent May?
Oh, Agent May.
Yeah, Agent May. So her and Ghost Rider is going at it, but it's him in his human form. But when he turns into the Ghost Rider, he fucks her up. And, like, he almost leaves her to die, but she was able to, like, get out of something.
So, can I clarify? So, obviously, this is not the Johnny
Blaze. Yeah, this isn't Johnny Blaze.
Does he have the exact same powers, except he's driving a car?
Yeah, so they don't really go too much into his powers, but he's still doing the same shit of killing bad people. So, like,
with vengeance.
For vengeance, yeah. So, like, Daisy is chasing, or Quake is chasing after him because he's murdering people, and, like, she's like, when they're fighting, she's like, yeah, you killed this innocent guy. He's like, you killed this cop. It's like, oh, no, you killed this teacher. It's like, no, that teacher was a fucking pedophile. He was, like, fucking kids and stuff like that. Or, like, he killed the cop because the cop was crooked and was, like, taking advantage of people and stuff like that. So he's killing people for a purpose, but she doesn't see that part of it. She just sees him killing people.
That's actually a cool concept.
Yeah, so yeah. This version of Ghost Rider, the comic is actually drawn by Trad Moore. It's the same guy that did shit.
Strode?
Yeah, Luther Strode. And he's a great artist. I wish he'd... Well, I'm pretty sure he does more stuff. I just gotta look into it. But the cover art and all the art in the book looks great. I bought the trade. I just haven't had a chance to read it yet.
Okay.
Well, I'm gonna get a priority, though, because it's not very long.
He's a Latin guy, right?
I have no idea. You're talking about...
Yeah, he's Latin.
The Ghost Rider is. Yeah, I thought you were talking about Trad. I have no idea.
Okay. Yeah, his name is Roberto Reyes.
Okay. Well, good shit.
And, yeah, it's pretty cool. So, the whole scene, when they first introduce him, you just get the car. And, like, if you read the comic, you knew who was there and, you know, like, the whole story behind them. But once those fucking tires light up on fire and that fucking flame come out of the engine, that shit was fucking badass. I give Marvel's or Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. props for bringing Ghost Rider on there. But I hope he's not the savior. I hope they're not jumping the shark with having Ghost Rider in there. Because they actually changed the time for Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. comes on at 10 now.
Do you think that he's going to be a reoccurring character throughout the year?
I fucking hope so. Yeah, because he's going to be in a few episodes.
He'll probably go up until maybe the break.
The mid-season finale?
Yeah.
So, okay. And maybe come back towards the end.
Because, yeah. I mean, I can't see him working for S.H.I.E.L.D. under any capacity.
No.
They're probably going to be chasing him, like, almost the whole season.
Yeah. And then there's also a ghost chick that's in the show now, too. I don't know who the fuck she is, because I'm not too heavy of a DC or a Marvel comic reader. But, yeah, like, there's some gangsters, some Asian gangster guys who receive this fucking box, and they open it up, and then, like, this ghost, like, appears behind, like, this one dude and starts whispering to his ear. And next thing I know, those fuckers are all, like, killing each other because, like, they're seeing shit. Like, I kind of want to think it might be the Enchantress. Maybe
Enchantress.
Yeah. But I'm not sure at this point. Somebody's got to update me on that one.
Enchantress. Well, what does the Infinity Vault say?
Yeah.
Let Kevin, us know. Where you at?
Yeah. All right.
So, Prodigy, you had something on here for a while now.
Which one?
The Africans are starting to complain about African Americans culturally appropriating.
I have had that on there a while.
Were you saving it for something, or
no? It wasn't that I was saving it. We just hadn't gotten to it. But it's something that kind of disturbed me, to be honest with you. So I saw it was online. There was an article written about basically, I think it was a Nigerian author or whatever, stating that anytime you see African Americans wearing kente cloth, wearing a dashiki, wearing any traditional African garb, they're really culturally appropriating from whatever tribe that is from. And I thought that was a very interesting perspective, given the fact that I have my own issues with the cultural appropriation bullshit. But Most of the time, they don't know what the tribe is if you're wearing it over here. They don't know anything from a cultural standpoint whatsoever with the clothing from Africa. And it was kind of eye-opening in terms of being able to say, you know what? It's not just one way with that quote-unquote cultural appropriation shit.
Well, first of all, I think cultural appropriation is fucking retarded. Second of all, what the fuck was he wearing?
Oh, wait.
T-shirt and jeans?
Yeah, exactly.
Or a
suit?
Yeah, that's American.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, yeah, he can go fuck himself.
Mm. Yeah, it might have been a girl, a female writer, but I can't remember.
Well, they're stupid either way. I mean, look, I've been to Africa. A lot of folks over there, they wear T-shirt and jeans. They're traditionally Western garb. There's nothing African about it.
Yep.
And I didn't think anything about cultural appropriation, because you know what? They're just clothes. If you want to wear T-shirt and jeans, wear T-shirt and jeans.
Yeah, no shit. Anybody should be able to wear what the fuck they want or eat. You know, and we actually talked about this even, I think, a little bit at San Francisco Comic Con, too, during those panels. But it was one article, and it just kind of disturbed me in terms of, again, people getting all butthurt about cultural appropriation when we should be able to do whatever the fuck we want.
So, yeah, I don't understand that. I mean, don't get me wrong. I think people look kind of, it's kind of odd to me that people in America wear clothes like that, but you can do it. I mean, that's your right to do it. And, it's just...
But you know what? You would stump 99% of them if you said, oh, okay, so what actual ethnic group or traditional ceremony is that associated with that you're wearing?
Yeah.
They wouldn't be able to answer that.
Yeah, when a white person wears a kimono or, a Vietnamese dress, usually no one says shit. Yeah. So,
yeah.
But usually most people I know that do that usually are dating someone of that ethnicity, or they're like...
I've seen it.
They got, a 32nd of that ethnicity within them or whatnot, but I think for me it's a little different because I've actually had a family member research our history to a tribe in Africa, so they knew what they were wearing. He went to visit them, wrote a book about it.
Actually, just like ancestry.com.
Yeah, he has a doctorate. He's a lawyer here. He managed to research from our own homesteads here all the way to Africa, went to Africa, met with the tribes, did the whole thing. They had a ritual about, they call it the Lost Ones, which is referred to us. And he spent, I think, a month with them, wrote a book about it. So.
But there wasn't any, DNA stuff, is what you're hearing, what you're saying.
I don't know if
you don't need DNA, though. You can go back just through.
Yeah, he went through records.
Yeah, you can go through records.
Well, I guess the thing that I've always heard is it's challenging for most to go back through records because there's a stopping point for a lot of those.
There is a stopping point, but for us, he managed to find and trace all the way back. I have the book. Actually, I have several copies of his book.
Okay. I know that just because Mishka's mom was actually really, really into this.
Yes, some of us that are African American, there are records that are either false, missing, or destroyed.
Yeah. All right.
So,
what I would like is for pretty much everybody that's African American here in the States to go visit Africa.
Why not?
I think it would give you a whole new perspective on life. Because the shit is over there is way different. I think people wouldn't. I think a good portion of people wouldn't consider themselves African American anymore once they visited Africa. So I'm not saying Africa's bad, but we're way different. It's way different from what you think it is.
There you go.
So, yeah.
Well, there was a thing that happened recently of I guess some kids went into a grocery store dressed in African clothing, and I guess the store clerk made some comment oh, is it Halloween or some shit like that? And it was clearly not nowhere near Halloween. And I guess they went home and told their mom. Their mom came back and was fucking pissed about it. And I mean, she kind of handled it wrong. She kind of went black ghetto mom, cussing woman out and stuff like that, but she didn't take the time to like educate her on stuff.
Yeah, I mean, it could just be a one-off comment. I mean, I don't know.
Well, it's the same problem. People think that Sikhs and Sheiks are the same, you know what I mean?
Or they think they're Muslim.
Yeah.
The hijabs.
Real quick to switch gears a little bit. How many? I think we got literally a week till Luke Cage drops, right?
Next week, I believe.
Yeah.
Fucking damn, it feels like it's taking forever on that shit.
I know.
I still haven't read any of the comics or whatever. And actually, Eton from Cape and Cowl.
Eton.
Recommended over in Oakland. Recommended a great trade paperback along with the same one that Mile High recommended.
Okay, cool.
God damn it. I gotta fucking get on that, man.
So we're actually going there on what day?
15th.
The 15th.
Of October.
It's payday. You know what that means? Come and buy some goddamn comics over at Cape and Cowl.
Yeah.
Wait, hold on. Are you sure? Might be the 14th.
It's that Friday.
It's pretty goddamn close to payday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bring your money.
Second Friday in the month of October. I can't fucking wait, man.
I gotta buy a bunch of new stuff when I go there. I want to pick up some trades. I want to get the Injustice trades for all the years and maybe get some Teen Titans.
Yeah, that way we won't feel bad because the way we've been getting them. But yeah.
All right.
Sorry, DC.
Well, kind of jumping back to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., so that ghost person I was talking about might lead into Doctor Strange.
Really?
With the Celots.
Okay.
So if you know who they are, that might... Because Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. do that. They kind of jump around from the TV show to the MCU movies.
I have low expectations or kind of medium expectations on Doctor Strange. This could blow some people away, though, if they do it right.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and really bring magic, obviously, into this. I want another Infinity Gem, goddammit, though. It's time.
Well, they're missing one or two, right?
At least two, I think. Yeah.
But we'll probably get it in, because we're getting closer to Infinity War starting to film, aren't we? Because Doctor Strange is...
This year,
and then what's after that?
I bet you Doctor Strange probably, or somebody's gonna have Soul.
Yeah, you got to.
I think it's Soul and Power we're missing, right? I'm seeing Power.
What colors do we have? We have purple, red. Is there green? There's blue.
Blue is Tesseract. Blue. So
yeah.
I know. Oh, yeah, purple's the ether.
You know what? Guardians 2 is going to have one.
Yeah. You know and I mean? That's next summer, yes?
Yeah. Whoever has power is going to be on the level of, like, the Hulk. So that'll be interesting.
Yep, it will. So...
You know what? Have they never had the, not the Infinity Gauntlet, but what's the other ones that are on Earth? What are those stones called? There's the Infinity Gem and there's something else, right? The one that,
The Mandarin?
The Mandarin.
Oh, the rings.
Oh, he had rings.
The 10 rings.
Yeah.
Oh, they're rings. Okay.
Because, at first he started with 5, then they added 10.
But the MCU has already ruined him, though.
Yeah, that's really did.
But what are the rings called?
They're just called the
10 rings. Oh, Makluan. I believe they're called the Makluan rings.
Oh, they're just the 10 rings of power or something like that.
Something like that, yeah.
All
right.
I just know people were still pissed about Iron Man 3 and that depiction.
I'm still mad about that.
There was that after the credit thing they showed where it made it seem like he was fake, like he was faking it all.
That was just a short, and I believe it's on Thor: The Dark World.
Yeah.
So you're
supposed to be interviewed in prison.
Yeah, he's been interviewed in prison. And they're saying that he's really the Mandarin and he was faking it or whatnot. Yeah.
So we were both right, old ninja. They're called the Ten Rings, and they are Makluan artifacts.
Okay. Ooh, okay.
Do they have? Holy shit! All right. I'm not going to go through all 10 of them, but
there's a lot. Yeah.
But we haven't seen them in the MCU at all, obviously. No. Or in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
I won't be surprised if they did that to lessen the confusion between the gems versus the rings.
Yeah, that would be confusing.
Yeah,
I've always been confused about that to begin with.
Well, the rings are way more powerful. I mean, the gems are way more powerful.
Yeah, I was going to say, definitely the gems.
They're like, so if you watch Dragon Balls, there's like the Earth Dragon Balls versus like the fucking Namek Dragon Balls, and then there's the new fucking Super Dragon Balls that are between dimensions. So if you're watching Dragon Ball Super, then you know what that shit's all about.
So wait, so in the MCU, we've seen the Mind Gem.
Yeah.
We've seen the Space Gem.
Okay.
Is that the one Michael Jordan has?
God damn it.
No, Space Jam. Have we seen the Soul Gem?
That's what I was saying.
I don't think so.
That would work great.
That's green.
Well, it would work great in...
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Shit.
Doctor Strange.
Doctor Strange, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and then we haven't seen the Time Gem, have we?
I don't think so. Not, yeah.
And then there's the Reality Gem, which is yellow.
That's what Vision should have.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Vision had that. So then he has that. So then we haven't seen two. We haven't seen the Time Gem and the Soul Gem.
And we're missing the Power
Gem. Or the Power Gem.
Yeah.
So we're missing three?
And goddamn it, we're still missing goddamn Thanos. I mean, it's like, holy fuck.
I mean, he's shown up.
I know he's coming.
And he looks great.
He's stuck in traffic.
we saw him in Guardians.
I need to get a size of scale with him, though, because you don't get a size of scale from what we've seen yet. But he needs to be big as fuck, like 8 feet tall.
I think that's why they made him CG.
Oh, you have to.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? With that, you can't just do it with makeup with that chin.
No, not with makeup, but you can do some camera tricks to make him look bigger.
It's going to be the same technology that they used with Mark Ruffalo with the Hulk. So part actor and part, you know, obviously CGI with the body and shit.
Oh, so this, I think this is the villain that they want to showcase. So all the other bitches as villains so far aren't going to compare to Thanos.
Yeah.
At least, I mean, what I suspect and I hope is that when the Infinity War, or whatever they're going to call it, comes out, we're going to lose some heroes.
We should lose a shitload of heroes.
Yeah. Better.
And millions, if not billions, better die.
Yeah. And, you know, the other thing is, obviously, Guardians has a very special relationship with Thanos already. With Nebula and Gamora.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And Drax.
I wonder what they're going to do with Drax, though, because they've already, like, kind of nerfed him.
They have, but they could power him up in one movie if you do it
sure
right.
Sure can.
Yeah.
You know, so they got a long way to go with that, but I can't wait for Guardians 2.
So, because I know that there's a few writers on that, so I don't know if Josh Whedon is writing or whatnot.
No, I think he's out. After Age of Ultron, he was sick of MCU.
No, I think he's more embarrassed.
Well, you know, so, it had some problems. It did. Perfect. All right, let's round it up, man. Old Ninja, what you getting into this week?
So, I'll be playing more Destiny, which I've already twitched out on our Twitch page. You can check out on twitch.tv/BeThemBTI. I've actually squatted up with one of our fans on Destiny. His gamer tag is Genius Brown. Okay. I don't know who that was, but we smashed a few times. And then I've been playing Star Trek Online a little bit. That's like my cooldown game. And then just trying to watch some of these shows and hopefully get up out my feelings by the end of the week. So
there you go. All right. Blue, what you got?
I am definitely going straight home and watching Mr. Fucking Robot. God damn it. Tonight's the season finale. We get to see what's been going on, how this all shit wraps up. Hopefully we get some answers to some fallen members and some background stories on some other shit. I'm also watching Scream Queens came back.
Yeah.
Oh, and shit, already?
Yeah, it came on last night, and it was fucking hilarious. They have Jason Stamos.
Oh, John Stamos.
They have Uncle Jesse in there.
John Stamos. Holy shit.
They have Uncle Jesse. I always get his name and the other guy.
Jason Statham.
Yeah. He's in there, and also the guy from the Twilight movies, the one that was the wolf,
yeah,
pretty boy, he's in there. Yeah, he's in there. But I have the original, the other cast members are back in there too. And I watched that today, actually. It was fucking hilarious, dude. I'm watching American Horror Story. That's fucking back. I'm watching that probably tomorrow because Mr. Robot's more important. I'm definitely going to catch up on some Fear the Walking Dead. I feel like something's happened this week. I'm gonna try to start. I gotta finish reading the Ultimate Spider-Man with Miles Morales because I borrowed Stitch's first trade, and I'm reading a second one now, and I haven't had a chance to pick it up. But I was listening to another podcast, and they went heavy on Miles Morales, and I'm like, holy shit, I gotta fucking read this comic book now.
He's a great character.
Yes.
And the second trade with the Venom War had me fucking floored. I can't wait for you to finish that.
Well, like, I know they kind of did like a bit of a spoiler in it where there's a fight scene in the hospital, and Miles' mom is a doctor.
Don't spoil the shit on here, but yes, there is that.
Yeah, I'm definitely gonna go start reading that. Other than that, you know, just I'm gonna try to do some more Telltale Batman because see, episode 2 is out, right?
Did it drop already?
I thought it did. I thought you emailed me about it.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I gotta finish up episode 1 and I'm gonna do episode 2. But yeah, I'm gonna be twitching that out. So definitely keep an eye out for that.
Curtis, what you got?
Just gonna be chilling this. Well, I guess the rest of the week because this is my Friday, so it's gonna be great. Get back to jiu-jitsu, watch that robot. Then catch up on some other shows that I haven't watched in a while. So yeah, and I need to finish watching Ash vs. Evil Dead. And yeah,
you're gonna try Atlanta, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna try Atlanta because I heard that.
About that.
I heard that Keith Ape was in there. Or a song by him was in there. So now I gotta watch it. Yeah. I'm gonna try to catch up on Flash as well.
Good shit, and I'm glad you're watching Flash, man. It's a good show, you know. And I know K-Mac loves it too. She's talked about it quite a bit.
Talk about how pretty this motherfucker is. We should stop watching the goddamn show. Fuck Barry Allen. I mean, not literally K-Mac.
Damn, she probably would.
Good shit, man. And I'm not doing a whole lot of shit except for trying to prepare for this goddamn beast of a Spartan race next weekend.
Oh. Y'all training?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's going to be a bitch.
I'm just going to go in the hyperbolic time chamber.
Oh, damn.
The day before.
There you go. But anyway, so doing that and then a whole lot of fucking Witcher. And so I still love that game. It's fucking perfect for me. All right.
Cool. This episode of the podcast is brought to you by Loot Crate. We just talked about all kinds of nerdy stuff that this is why they're a perfect sponsor for us.
Mm-hmm.
last month's, I think it was last month's, because the last one that I got, because the mail system really messed up my Loot Crate. I got my box all messed up and like super late, but it wasn't Loot Crate's fault. It was the Postal Service's fault because I moved. But I know the last one that I got was for Harley Quinn. We just talked about her in this episode. Basically, the coolest thing about this box is that you can actually break the box down and then reform it into like Harley Quinn's mallet. How cool is that?
That's fucking dope.
I never even thought about doing something like that. It's like cool origami, man.
I actually brought that on the cast a couple shows ago.
Yes.
So you can see what it looked like.
It was pretty cool. So another thing that Loot Crate does, they have all kinds of other different kinds of boxes that we talked about at the beginning of the episode, but we'll go over it again. Loot Crate Gaming, it's one if you like gaming geared stuff, which I do, but...
Everybody does.
Everybody does. Yeah, they got Loot Pets, Loot Crate DX for all you ballers, Loot Wear for all y'all on a budget, and they also have strategic partnerships with other folks, like they have a Halo box, they have a WWE Slam Crate, they got Marvel Gear and Gear and Goods. Sorry, I'm messing up all of them. And then Call of Duty stuff, all kinds of stuff. So yeah, if you go over to trylootcrate.com/BNBTI with the promo code BRIDGE10, you will save 10% on your new subscription. Once again, that's trylootcrate.com/BNBTI with the promo code of BRIDGE10, and it will save you 10% on a new subscription. Don't forget to go to the /BNBTI. It's important. If you don't and you just put in the promo code, then we don't get the credit for it.
Now, what was that Loot Crate fangirl thing? What was that? Can you click on that real quick? Because that looks like something that a bunch of females would be into.
Oh, yeah. Loot for fangirls. Oh, the limited edition crates.
Oh, okay. That's
so
what it is.
I don't know if they have them all the time.
Yeah, and I believe this month's theme for Loot Crate is speed. It's all speed-based, so there's going to have some stuff from, like, Back to the Future, some Batman stuff in there, The Flash. They might have some stuff from Battlestar Galactica up in there. So the whole theme for this month is going to be speed-based.
Awesome. Okay, so I'm looking at the Loot for Fangirls. They have a special edition crate, and basically you can purchase this. I'm not sure if it's a subscription or not. Basically, you get 5 exclusive items for, basically, it's female, you know, yeah, orientated. So it comes with, like, dresses, like, makeup stuff. Yeah, you know, like, accessories, cosmetics, stuff like that. It looks pretty cool. Actually, Kim actually did that.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, it's $65, and it's a guaranteed $100 or more value.
I like it.
Pretty sick. Is that dress pixelated, or is it just...
It's pixelated, so we don't know what it
pixelated.
Is.
Pixelated. Yeah. Because I know they have that, like those glasses that are pixelated or like the swords and stuff, but yeah.
Yeah, they're just not sure what it is because they want it to be a surprise.
There we go.
Surprise, mother. There is a
story so strange. All right. We got it?
Yes.
So don't forget to go on iTunes and rate us. Give us that 5 stars.
Leave a comment.
Yeah, you can look for us, BTI, almost anywhere. Twitter,
and use
Facebook.
That new hashtag for our Ash vs. Evil Dead.
Instagram as well.
Oh, yeah, we're on Instagram.
And also, if you have Amazon Fire Stick or Fire TV, you can actually find an app where our videos are posted onto there directly. And shout out to
Shopper Supreme.
Yeah, is that what I think, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, for making that app for us. That's great.
Good shit. Thank you.
I always forget to mention that part.
Yeah. Don't forget to check out Before and After the Cast.
And smash that subscribe button on this YouTube channel.
Woo!
Yet many questions remain unanswered.
Eggplants are in our future.
Inside.